Delicious.
Okay.
It's happening live on the stream.
I'm gonna have a coffee. I haven't had a coffee in so long. What is that gonna mean?
You're gonna be bouncing off the wall.
You're gonna feel good.
You're gonna short circuit.
No, I don't want a short circuit.
No, we got a long.
You're gonna
circuit.
Be real happy, and then you're gonna be.
Dunk. I didn't take my AMs.
Wow, she read your mind.
You're really onward. Intergalactic, planetary, intergalactic.
Instagalactic.
You
traded
in, I like to move
it. I like to move it.
Oh, cool, I steamed the water and then never actually gave you the thing.
Cool.
Let's get that door we want. Perfect.
Peanut butter.
I don't know, they all taste a little bit.
I like them.
You do?
They're a little chalky.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe if you, like, warm them up a bit. Perhaps.
I'm not complaining.
Oh. So you're going to be up there again, and then down here.
Oh, awesome.
Which door it is, so we'll just...
I'm not looking.
Oh, that one.
No, come on.
Jeremy just came in the emergency exit.
I love him so much.
Yeah. Jeremy does his own thing.
Okay, all right, yes you can. You're welcome to come as you are, whichever door you are in. Just make sure you walk through the door. Hi, how are you, David?
I'm so
good,
thanks.
Nice to see you. Welcome to Witness Worldwide.
Woo-woo.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you doing?
I'm doing well. Is this weird?
Well, it's weird that I have to drive from, as I'm your next door neighbor,
can do that.
From my house to come to your other house.
Right? How are you guys? Yeah. Welcome. Okay, everyone, there's Nugget. She says hi.
Sweetie.
She just likes to like snuggle in the pillows.
She's a PA.
You say hi to Jeremy. You be a good girl.
What's up, baby? What's up, baby?
She's a cutie. Everybody here at Witness Worldwide, this is the incredible Jeremy Scott, and this is the incredible David Bond. Nugget, we know you exist, and it's not your time. And we're gonna have a little conversation, just like we're kind of like doing these like walks down memory lane today. And then we're gonna talk about all of the things that are so wonderful that you help out with.
Great.
Yes, because today is Pride in LA, yes. And everyone's out having a great time, and we're having a great time in here, aren't we? We don't wish we could be out there in the world, just, you know, trying things and seeing things. We did this to ourselves. I got to pick up those cards.
That's cool. I did the 3.5 mile march this morning.
You did?
Right.
I wanted to hear
but
all
I understand that. You've been up since, like, the break of dawn, so I was like, if either one of us are exhausted, it's
no,
much
it's
more
not actually since the break of dawn. I've been up since about 9:30. But, you know, that's pretty normal for me. Let's take a seat. Can I offer any of you guys some water?
Sure.
Would you like a sparkling water?
I'll take a sparkling water.
Flat, please. Okay.
Flat.
Thank you. This is awesome. I'm going to grab my water. Hi, guys.
Hi.
This is Jeremy Scott, who I've known forever and ever and ever. and that I love forever. How was your show, by the way?
Doing really well.
I'm sorry I couldn't be there.
Yes, sweetheart, you're in the middle of a whole nother experience.
I was in the middle of this house. And how was it, the Moschino show? I'm wearing Moschino, by the way.
I know, you look gorgeous in it.
Do I look like an alien?
A little bit.
That's okay, right? Look at all these cameras, aren't they fun? And weird? And it's so good to have you here, because you're one of my wisest friends.
Aw.
And I have known you for a long time, and you've always been so kind to me. And we were looking at some of those music videos earlier with Marcus and Johnny, and how you gave me like clothes in the very, very, very beginning.
Yeah.
And I just want to talk about friendship.
Sure.
And I just want to talk about your story, or I want you to share with everyone about your story.
Okay.
Because today is Pride, and as Marcus and Johnny remind me, every day is Pride for them. Absolutely. And it's Gay Pride Month.
Yes.
In all of the U.S., or is it it changes? You might know better than I.
I can tell you a couple things about
it. Okay, sure. Please tell us what that means for people that are watching.
Sure. So June is Gay Pride Month, or it's LGBTQ Pride Month. And so even though some cities have their prides on different weekends, usually throughout the summer, June is like officially our...
That's the O-fish.
Exactly.
Exactly. And that's the time that you guys come together and have a community and celebrate your individuality.
Exactly.
And it's just about a sense of community.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about reaching out and making friends and knowing that you have allies.
Exactly.
And that's what the Trevor Project is all about. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah.
Because I love the Trevor Project, and I've been to your facility. I've seen how amazing it is in real time. And the hotline, can you please just tell us about the hotline and tell us about everything? Go ahead.
For sure. And we were just talking outside as well about how I joined the Trevor Project a little bit over 4 years ago, right after you were at our gala in Los Angeles. So I missed you by like 5 months, and I said this was gonna be the moment that I met Katy Perry.
No.
And then it was like, well, I waited 4 years, and now I can.
So it's all timing.
The Trevor Project. We're almost 20 years old, and we are the only national accredited suicide prevention and crisis intervention organization for LGBTQ young people.
Amazing.
And we specialize.
The only one.
The only one.
The only hotline.
The only accredited hotline.
What does accredited mean then?
Well, we're accredited by the American Association of Suicidology,
which
means...
So like you're legit.
Yeah.
Too
so,
legit,
like, we're
legit to quit.
Exactly.
Right, got it.
We're super legit. So our counselors go through like 40 hours of training before.
Right. It's not just like you're calling your friend to have a chat, even though sometimes it's nice just to reach out to a friend.
Well, we have those programs too.
This is different.
Right. So we have the 24-hour lifeline, and we also have digital programs where you can text or chat with us every day during the week.
Digital programs.
Yeah.
Amazing.
And then Trevor Space is what you're talking about. So it's more like peer support program where young people can go to trevorspace.org.
Right.
And it's kind of like, it's a social media platform, but just
Trevor
for LGBTQ
Space.
Young people. Trevor Space.
Okay, fantastic.
Exactly.
Is it an app that you can download, or is it just
not,
a website?
It's a website, but it is mobile responsive design, so you can do it from your handheld
Amazing.
Device as well.
And what's the purpose and what's the goal of the Trevor Project? Maybe some background.
Yeah, so
because some people are, you know, some people are hearing about it for the very first time.
Sure.
What is the Trevor Project?
I'd be surprised if your fans are hearing about it for the first time.
You never
know. Because you're so good at talking about it.
Well, no. you never know. Some people, you know, I don't know everything, and I'm learning so much as everyone can witness.
Mm-hmm.
And it's exciting to get new information, so.
Well, I can tell you, all right, so I'll tell you a bit, and so I'm the clinical person on the executive team, so usually at our, you know, like if we're having a fundraiser or cocktail parties, I'm not the one people want to talk to, because I'm actually the one who handles the suicide prevention programs.
Right.
So suicide, and I'll just give you a quick nutshell of it, though.
Please.
Suicide is the second leading cause of death for all young people in this country between the ages of 10 and 24.
For all young people?
Mm-hmm.
10 and 24?
10, ages 10 to 24. Actually, now it's ages 10 through 34. Wow. Suicide is the second leading cause of death.
Really?
Right. So, number one, people always ask me, like, well, what's higher than that? And it's car accidents.
Really?
Mm-hmm. But here's the interesting thing.
That's so in the USA.
In the United States.
That's
right.
So crazy.
That's right. And there are other countries that are better and worse off than than our rates. But lesbian, gay, and bi youth are about 4.5 times more likely to attempt suicide than straight youth. Mm-hmm. You've probably heard that statistic. And trans youth, about 40% of trans people say that they have had a suicide attempt at some time in their life. But here's a really important thing. When you're talking about LGBTQ young people and suicide, to never talk like it's an expected outcome.
Sure.
Like, oh, you're queer, so you're probably going to try it. You're probably going to be a suicidal. And that's a real false narrative, it's a harmful narrative.
Is it called
stigma?
It's a bad narrative.
Exactly. It's a really false narrative. Now, there is stigma around people who have survived a suicide attempt, because they should be able to tell their story.
Absolutely. What is that? Redefine what stigma means then.
Sure. So, gosh, let me tell you conceptually about mental health and stigma, for example. So if a woman has breast cancer and she's a breast cancer survivor, everyone expects, like, wow, she's so brave and look what she lived through and she can talk about it and we can all talk about this thing she went through.
Right.
But if you have depression or intense anxiety or PTSD or if you have thoughts of suicide, nobody wants to really hear about it. There's so much shame involved in it. And that's why it's a major public health issue for us. Because nationwide, it's the second leading cause of death. But it's something that we're scared
of talking about. Shame is the worst.
Yeah. Yeah.
That is worse, because we need to have these conversations. I feel like they're hard. Mm-hmm. You know, because everybody wants to just be like, life is great. I mean, look at me. I'm bouncing around, bouncing off the walls, you know, like learning meditation and having wonderful conversations. But like, I've had those thoughts. Mm-hmm. I talk about having those thoughts. I wrote a song called By the Grace of God. Like, I had to pick myself up over the bathroom floor. Tamara was there. Like, I've had those thoughts, you know. I've been through that thing, you know, that is feels shameful. And you're like Katy Perry, like the person that played the Super Bowl and like, you know, dates the hottest guys in the world. You would name
you
like
you have a
bad boyfriend. But has like all the things that you just dream about in a fairy tale. Like she should just be the absolute happiest.
Mental health affects everybody.
Mental health
affects everyone.
Affects it does not.
Mm-hmm. Does not discriminate.
That's what I was looking for. It's not discriminate. And it's real. Mm-hmm. It's not some fairy tale. And I deal with it every day as well. You know, it's like this weird thing, this weird experiment, you know? And like, people out there need a place to talk to people. Mm-hmm. And I don't think they know that there's a place every day that they can just call 24 hours a day, pick up the phone, you know, and they can talk about it.
Mm-hmm. And that's what the message that we would want to give is like, no matter what you're going through, there is always someone who can help.
Yeah.
And if what we want to really encourage is help-seeking behavior. And there's a shame and stigma around that, too.
There's a shame and stigma about asking for help.
Yeah. And I got to tell you, even speaking as a white person with all the privilege that comes with that,
absolutely, 100%.
I come from a culture where, like, if there's something wrong with me, I get to go to the doctor. I get to go to the hospital.
100%.
When I was a child, I could go see a therapist, and that was fine because of the family I came from. But so many other intersecting identities have such, like, the family doesn't want to talk about it, or we want to pretend it's not
happening. Don't talk about feelings.
So it's really complicated for those young people.
Yeah, pretend it's not happening.
Exactly.
That's a big one, huh? I can't imagine.
And the levels, so like the things that stress me out are going to be super different from the things that stress you out or you, right? But my level 10 stress is still my level 10 stress.
Oh, yeah.
Just like it is for a celebrity or a princess or, you know, a wealthy person or a homeless person.
No. Nothing is promised.
Right. Yeah.
You know, nothing is promised. And I think that it's amazing. So Trevor Project is almost 20 years old. And how did it start?
I'm glad that you asked. So so many people come up to me and they say, who was Trevor?
Yeah.
There wasn't. Trevor is a movie. It was an Academy Award winning short film. And in 1998, it aired on HBO. And Ellen introduced it. It was right around Ellen's coming out period as well. So the makers of the film knew we can't put this on HBO. It was the Trevor is about like a 12 or 13 year old boy who falls in love with another boy at his school, and it gets out, and he goes through a very hard time of it. And he eventually does attempt suicide, but he survives. And the story, it's not a dark story.
No.
But it's one about hope and sort of a coming of age, which unfortunately has a very potentially devastating event in it, but he survives and is okay at the end of it. Anyway, the point of it was that the filmmakers knew we can't air this movie without having a resource available for kids who are going through what this kid went through.
It's not an art piece.
Yeah.
It's real life.
It was what's fascinating too is now suicidology is a thing. It's a real field.
Suicidology.
And we're a whole suicide prevention community, and there are lots of us doing it. But messaging around suicide is so important. So it's important to have conversations in the news, in the media, in social media, and television shows that talk about suicide in a healthy way. Mm-hmm. Not that suicide is healthy, but talk about it in a way that prevents contagion and that helps people stay safe.
A lot of people have those thoughts.
And if you don't, that you absolutely must, every time you talk about suicide prevention, list a hotline number where you can call.
Right.
So they're
probably listing it right now, as I hope. I hope they're listening. I hope they're listening, or we're sending you to a link where you can find it right now, because some people are like, whoa, I need something like that right now. I needed it yesterday, you know?
And we have really well-trained counselors all across the country who are there and ready to help.
Amazing. Yeah. And Jeremy, tell me about your life and how you got to where you're at now, the fabulous Jeremy Scott, who both runs and designs Moschino and your own line, and you make us also happy with the colors and the textures and the way we get to present and decorate ourselves.
Well, where do I begin?
Where are you from?
I'm from Kansas City, Missouri. I grew up on a
Kansas City, Missouri. Exactly. Grew up on a farm.
Grew up on a farm outside of Kansas City, Missouri. And went to school in New York City, and then went to
How did you even get the idea to go to New York City? Like, because you can't just go like, hi, I'm from Kansas City, and I'm gonna go to New York City. Yeah. Like, how did you do that?
Honestly, I always loved clothes, and I loved fashion, but I just thought it was something I liked, and it was just a passion. It was like getting dressed, and I would try to dress my friends, and we'd get dressed for school, and it was just kind of the something I enjoyed.
Right.
I was doing ceramics at school, and I was
all You were still in the arts?
Yeah, I was just doing pottery, making handmade paper sculptures. I didn't really think of it as a job. And one of my art teachers told me, well, why don't you go to fashion school? And, okay, this is interesting. So I sent out my portfolio and a letter to FIT in New York, and then got a rejection letter saying that I lacked artistic ability, creativity, and originality.
Cool. And it was like all the things that are your Twitter bio.
Yeah, and I was like devastated, you know, being, I don't know, 17 and kind of having like what seems like an authority tell you that you are nothing.
Sure.
So I ended up going to New York to NYU for art history at first, and then thought I'll go look at the schools there and try in person. We'll see if maybe it's a difference.
Yeah, so tell me to my face. That's basically what you're saying.
Exactly. So I made appointments for Parsons, FIT, and Pratt. So
and how did you educate yourself on that? Did you have, like, where did you go to high school?
Where did I go to high school?
Yeah.
In Kansas City.
Kansas City. Cool. Yeah. And like you went on the internet and you found it?
Internet didn't exist then.
Oh, I didn't know. I thought the internet has always.
It was a little different. It was harder to get information.
So you educated yourself.
Yeah. I don't really remember now how. I mean, honestly, I have a hard time remembering how we do anything without the internet.
I know.
But I did live at that time when there wasn't cell phones. I know. And when there wasn't, you know, everything is accessible.
Jeremy, what was that timeline like without the cell phone?
And I was on a farm, woman.
Oh my gosh.
I had to walk to school.
Oh my gosh.
Wearing a potato sack.
By the way, that potato sack on the runway looks fabulous now. It's got a big Jeremy Scott on it, and
exactly.
It's like couture.
But you know, I made it to New York and saw the other schools, and then felt like I was heard for the first time in my life. And
why? Because what was going on in Kansas?
Well,
what was going on in Kansas, Dorothy?
Very much like what he's describing. I mean, I was nearly every day at school. I was assaulted, physically, verbally. It was I'd been hit by boys and girls, and it was just like acceptable. I mean, I remember the first day of high school and pitcher day. Like, we'd go get your pitcher done, and school hadn't started yet. At least that's the way it was in Missouri. Mm-hmm. And I got chased through the halls by a skinhead who told me he was going to, like, effing kill me. And I was like, oh my God, school hasn't even started, and this is how it is.
Can I jump in there about Missouri for a second, too? Missouri is, a little factoid here, one of only two states in the entire country which specifically prohibits LGBT young people from being protected in their anti-bully policies in the schools.
Which is something, yes.
Yeah. There are a lot of states that are great. They protect people from bullying in schools and specifically protect marginalized communities.
Absolutely.
Missouri and one other state.
What's that other state?
South Dakota.
Okay, South Dakota, yeah. Missouri. We need to have a little come
we
to Jesus.
We need to have some conversations.
Yes. We need to have some hard conversations. We love you. But mm-hmm. And we hope that you love the people that live there.
And it's good. Well, so I gave a talk in St. Louis just last in April too.
Yeah.
And the audience was actually great. So it's not, I mean, it's not a whole state full of people who feel that way.
Well, that's
right?
The thing is like,
it's just the people who get elected.
Well, but that's the thing is that like in a lot of this, it's like, I think that people at their core are amazing and they want the best for each other. I mean, I truly think people are meant to be good people. Mm-hmm. Like they're created as good people that want to do good. And just like somewhere along the way, someone who doesn't stand for what's right or who is perverted or who wants destruction starts to be like, I'm speaking for everyone. And it's like, mm-hmm. Wait, hold on. You're not speaking for everyone here, you know? And I think that that's unfortunate that is not, there's not a protection there because I think that is necessary for all kinds of people, for all kinds of people that are social injustices, mm-hmm. that are suffering, whatever their situation is like, we need to protect those people. But that's horrible that happened on, and I'm sure you were like all excited to take that one photo that was going to, you know, be that throwback photo for rest of time.
Well, actually, after
is that popping up on the
I
screen
stopped,
right now.
No, because I stopped doing the yearbook picture because I was like, one day I'm going to be famous and I want people to dig up these old photos.
You were smart.
I was smart.
You were smart.
But yeah, I mean, it was challenging. It's a challenging place to grow up gay, for sure. And I remember my boyfriend was a senior when I was a freshman. And he wanted me to go to prom with him, and I wouldn't do it. I was like, I can't do this because I can't be here. I graduated 90s? In 91, so it was like 88, something like that. And I was like, I can't go to prom with you, and you're graduating. I'm going to be left here as the only, you know, the faggot that went to school with prom, and there's no one else here left.
There
to
wasn't
take
anyone
care of
else?
Me. Not open about
right,
it.
Right.
I mean, and so.
You were.
Part of me regrets it because I wish I could have done that, but this is before Glee. This before, you know, this is a world before all your fans can really understand what it was like, and in a place, as you're explaining, that's a lot different.
It might have really been the responsible decision for your safety, too, right? Because we talk, so many people say, come out. No.
Like,
do a realistic safety assessment of your home, your church, your community, your school.
Right.
And if you're not going to be safe,
hold
on to it and come out to the people you will be safe with.
Yes, you have to create a safe place to be able to share those deep things.
Mm-hmm.
I can understand in that way. Well, it's amazing. I think that, you know, you've come so far and you've shown how resilient you are. That's like a key word. It's like people are really feeling resilient. And I know that there's a lot of people that are watching that are maybe like young and just, you know, figuring out who they are and they don't know and they're in a strange situation. Like, you know, even growing up, I wasn't allowed to be friends openly with the LGBTQ community, and so I had no point of reference.
Sure.
I literally had no point of reference until I left my bubble about, like, what the LGBTQ community is. I had all these kind of conditioning references. And, like, you know, I had this idea about conversion camp and, like, that it was a real thing. And, you know, along the way, in my own life and even in my own career, I made some mistakes because I just was not educated. I did not have the information. And so what I get to do now is I get to re-educate myself and I get to surround myself with good literature, great documentaries, great information, my allies, people like Trevor Project, people like GLSEN, like the Human Rights Campaign. I get to surround myself with all those people that are smarter, you know, that have the information, that have the tools, and you guys have this hotline, once again, that I think separates you from a lot of people, even though we're all in this together, we're all working together, together for the greater good. But this hotline, I think, is so imperative that you could just pick up the phone and call, and, you know, people, like, need that. They need someone, even if it's anonymous, that they can say, hey, I'm having a bad day, and I'm having these thoughts. can you just like talk me through it for 5 minutes? Like 15 minutes? Just talk to me, you know? That's all. Sometimes you just need that human connection.
Absolutely. I'm just craving compassion from somebody. Yeah. Not getting it from anybody.
Exactly, exactly. And I think that's so brilliant. And I just feel like, you know, I owe a lot of my success to the LGBT community, and they have always supported me. And yes, you know, I haven't gotten it right sometimes along the way, and they've befriended me, and they've, you know, had compassion for me. And I just feel like I feel so grateful that I have come so far, and I still have so far to go, but that, like, so grateful that there is such a love and there's such a realness in this community that you can really feel, and it's there. I mean, and that's why you guys are out today at Pride. And how was the march? Tell me.
It was amazing. So in Los Angeles traded its Pride parade for today's national march to be a part of something much, much bigger nationwide, and some cities chose to. Anyway, so it was so amazing. It was kind of akin to the Women's March. I don't know if it was quite the size, but it felt that way being in the middle of it. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna guess about crowd size. But it was fascinating in so many ways. You were talking about like the clever signs that people were holding up.
Yeah.
It was so meaningful because particularly right now where the community is being challenged and threatened in ways that we thought we had moved past.
It's crazy.
So coming together to realize that, you know, like we're not alone, and just not even your group, like there's so many intersecting identities.
It's my favorite word, intersectionality.
Exactly.
It really is my favorite word, because it's just like there's so many people that can come together that have some of the same similar sets of, you know, difficulties and struggles. It's amazing to see all of them coming together.
And what's so fascinating too is like, so being like a white cisgender gay man, I'm like, I have privilege, oppression.
Absolutely.
But there are other people who might be like a black trans woman, it's where it's oppression.
Yeah.
But like everyone's experience of oppression and privilege is so different.
Yep.
But like on a day like this or an event like this, when you're recognizing genuine community among everybody, and that when you mess with one of us, you mess with all of us.
Together.
And when we all protect each other, we're a community that's
protected. We're all brothers and sisters.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And it's amazing. Exactly. I love that.
I'm so sorry to be interrupting you, but your mic is dead and we're not hearing anything.
Oh, you're not?
Yeah. It was a weird buzz, but...
You're hearing...
It's just a weird buzz. They heard it, but there was a weird buzz is what they're
talking. Oh, there's a weird buzz.
Sorry.
I'm so sorry.
I thought it was
really
all
meaningful and powerful.
No, it was. You are. It's okay. You are. You still are. You are still brilliant.
No, sorry, you even help my.
No, that's okay. Do you want the bottom
getting
end of that?
Getting all up close and personal. Is it up
under my? That's okay. That's really exciting. There.
I unclipped you. Yeah.
Oh, then I'm.
So where can kids go? I know the TrevorProject.com.
Org, excuse me. TheTrevorProject.org.
TheTrevorProject.org.
Exactly. And you can learn all about not just our crisis services,
right,
but also we have nationwide education programs.
Great.
And what I would really suggest, if there are any educators, teachers, or even, you know, students watching, that on our education page, there's it's called the Lifeguard Workshop, which any teacher anywhere in the country can do in their classroom. So it's a video and a curriculum and classroom activities all talking about suicide prevention. I was saying before, you know, suicide is the second leading cause of death. Number one is motor vehicle accidents, but we teach children wear your seatbelt, and we put in safer crosswalks, and we have zero tolerance for texting and driving and drinking and driving. And since 2000, we've reduced motor vehicle fatalities in this country by 35% to 40%.
Right.
If we start talking about how to keep each other safe,
right,
and what are the warning signs that someone's thinking about suicide or considering it, and how to reach out to that person.
Do we know any of those warning signs? I know they're all different.
Let's talk about it.
We're here.
Sure. Okay. So I'll wrap up that one so I don't put a pin in it. It's called the Lifeguard Workshop. Talk your teacher into doing it in the classroom, and then also our research programs and our advocacy programs for some legislative agenda that we have.
We need that legislative agenda.
We do. We do. So we work really hard on banning conversion therapy. On state by state, because we're probably not going to get very far at the federal level at this point, but we can do a state by state thing.
So it's all state by state. What does that mean? Can you tell people?
Sure.
Sometimes, like, you know, politics are really, like, I don't understand a lot.
So New Jersey was first, and California was right up there. So right now there are 5 states and a number of city jurisdictions which have banned conversion therapy altogether. So if you're a minor and your parents are requiring you to go to, as a psychotherapist, I'm offended because there's nothing therapeutic about it. You can't call it,
trust
you shouldn't call
it
therapy.
I was in youth group and I heard all about it.
Right. Well, then you know what I'm talking about. So if you are in California, New Jersey, one of these states, and you're a minor, and your parents are requiring you to go to this, it's actually reportable as child abuse. Because it's a fraudulent, I mean, it's not therapy, and it's actually harmful. It's not helpful. Mm-hmm. And it will never succeed in its goals, because you cannot change gender identity or sexual orientation through this kind of practice, or any really. So the policy agenda is out there for that. Also for requiring schools to do suicide prevention education in the classroom or in schools. California just passed that.
And that's a requirement now.
It is. Starting in the next school year, every school in California will be required to have policies in place.
It's not a joke. Mm-hmm. Like, I really don't know if people are joking or what have you, but like, I see those comments sometimes, even while I've been on this live stream, I've seen a couple of comments where it looks as though kids are trying to reach out. Like it's their last straw. They don't know what to do. Please talk to me. I'm in a dark place. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know what to do. And they're just reaching out. You know, and I'm like, well, is this real? And I think that some of those signs are real.
Oh yeah.
They're really real.
Yeah, it is. I think there's a, it's a misnomer almost to say, oh, that's just a cry for help.
No.
Because the truth is, it might be a cry for help, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't help somebody.
Sure.
I mean, it's a good thing that someone is crying out for help.
Yeah.
And people saying that someone is just doing something for attention is also, well, then they need some kind of care, and they're letting you know that they need some kind of care. So warning signs, like you asked about.
This is their best way they know possible.
Yeah. So
warning signs
that you talked about, oftentimes it can be social withdrawal. Now we're not talking about, like, some people are just introverted, but like, I used to be very social, I used to post a lot more, and I've kind of stepped back from a public stage, right? There are similar signs to depression and anxiety, you know, like someone, also teenagers experiment with drugs and alcohol, we know this to be true, but when it gets to be really problematic, keep an eye on that. Because that can't, you know, that young person is coping in ways that are generally not healthy. Yeah.
Right? I had a friend that passed, that took his own life, and that's why, like, when you said it, it went, oh, because it was so weird. I mean, I knew he was battling with depression, and it was so weird. I was doing that, you know, Instagram scroll. And I saw that he had posted one picture, and it had no caption. And it was just of him, and it was a beautiful picture of him and his face and his body, like, and he was kind of leaning against a wall. And I looked at it, and I remember I stopped, and I looked at it, and I was like, this is weird. There was a weird thing. Mm-hmm. It was a weird feeling. Because he doesn't post things without captions, you know, and like, he would post all kinds of stuff, and it always would have a blurb about it. And he posted, and I was just weird, and I just kept scrolling, you know, and I didn't know. And I knew that, like, he had battled with depression, but I just thought, you know, that's going to be maybe his thing, and it was his constant battle, because sometimes depression can be a constant battle. And, like, if I would have known those signs, maybe I would have known.
Yeah, but you can't also take that on.
No, I know, but like, this is why we need to have these conversations.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. And we talk about, and I'm glad that you were vulnerable enough to even be able to share that. And we talk
that's why we need to have these conversations.
Yeah. Suicide is preventable, but it doesn't always mean you could have done something
absolutely
to prevent that person.
No, but like, I'm a friend, and I could have reached out in a different way, just, hey, you okay? I love you, you know? That's all it takes is like, hey, are you okay? I love you. You know, sometimes, not all it takes, but sometimes it's like that little thing is what helps, you know?
Yeah, yeah. You're absolutely right. And even if it's just a, hey, if you ever want to talk, right? And
just to know.
I'm here for you.
Yeah.
And Facebook actually has a new, I'm not allowed to talk about Facebook, it's good.
It's okay.
Okay, so they actually have a new thing where if someone posts a picture or has a social media post that makes you worried about them, there's a whole suicide prevention flow from the drop-down menu.
Really?
That ultimately results in, when you say, this looks like it's about self-harm or suicide,
right,
then Facebook pops up with, what would you like to do about it? Would you like to reach out to that person yourself, and here's some language you can use?
Wow.
Would you like to recruit more friends to help you reach out to this person?
Wow.
Or do you want Facebook, do you want us to do it? Like, wow, a safety assessment, which is really cool.
And by then the way, gives that's the user so beautiful, yeah. And I commend them, yeah. And like, I hope that, you know, that is a great example that we can use all of our social media, all of, mm-hmm, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, all these things that are giving us this platform to be able to really connect. Because sometimes it's a fake connection. Mm-hmm. We all know that to be, mm-hmm, true, and we hide behind these like things. But like, it'd be amazing if we can see, you know, we can communicate, be better communicators, yeah, because of that.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Can I give you a couple what not to do?
Yes, please. Let us know what we shouldn't do, because we don't want to be those people.
Good. So we, here are a couple of really important what not to do. And if you have, if you have done these things, this is not for to shame anyone, but just for moving forward.
Moving forward.
If someone has died by suicide, we don't post that person's suicide letter. Mm-hmm. And we don't put the word suicide in the headline.
Really?
And this is a little controversial, but anyone who is a suicide prevention professional will tell you the exact same thing.
Really?
So the challenge is, you want to honor the loss of that person and, absolutely, honor their family's loss and their loved one's loss, right, you don't want anyone to look like a martyr because of their suicide. There are people who are famous now because they died by suicide.
And that is what? Not
and
a good
it
example.
It triggers contagion. Mm-hmm. Contagion is a real thing. So if you are, if you see irresponsibly reported stories about suicide, people who are not suicidal, it doesn't necessarily make them suicidal suddenly.
Right.
But people who are struggling with thoughts of depression, right, suicide, see this and it sort of normalizes their experience and it normalizes,
right,
suicide, which we don't want to
it's
do.
It's not, right.
Right. So you don't say like the mechanism of death. You know, you can say like, we lost this person to suicide, but you don't say the means. Like, you don't want to do something that creates a visual image of the scene in someone's mind, because that can be really traumatic and triggering for a lot of people.
Right, and their families.
Exactly.
And it could maybe dismiss that their beautiful life and what they gave while they were here.
Yeah, yeah.
Understood. Any exactly. other tips?
I think that one is, so I think even some of your viewers will think about, because there have been some very famous posting of suicide letters later on. It's complicated for schools too, because schools are instructed not to memorialize people who die by suicide. It's a fear of contagion, because other people say, well, look at all the attention this person got now,
right,
after their death. Or won't you be sorry when I'm gone?
Right.
Like, you're sorry when he was gone, you know? And so you don't really want to reinforce that, but
that's not a good thing.
No, because that's not, yeah, exactly. That's you want to have messages that talk about hope, like every, you know, like they're hope is important, but also resources.
Right.
And that there's access to care.
Right.
And we want you to access, right, that care.
And mental health is real.
Yeah.
It is real. It's not a figment of your imagination.
Mm-hmm.
It's not someone having PMS. It's not someone having a bad day just because something didn't go their way. It's real. It's real as your real health, as you going to the doctor, your mind, it's real. All of that is very real. And like, for me, you know, I think growing up, I wasn't able to talk about feelings. And look, I have a lot of them. Like, I mean, I really, like, I have so many feelings all the time, and I love feeling them, and sometimes they can get really overwhelming. And, you know, I feel really grateful I get this opportunity to, like, work my feelings through a medium, through art, you know, through creating, and, like, it's my own type of therapy in a way, and I get to also go to therapy, and I know that that's my privilege, and I know that it's an amazing way, you know, just a hotline is an amazing way, a free hotline just to call up. So thank you. And I know today we're going to do a little exercise. What are we going to do, Jeremy?
We're going to create a t-shirt with the funds going to support the TREVOR project.
That's right, because you are the designer extraordinaire, and I might say I'm...
No, you're not bad yourself.
I've been a muse once.
Oh my God, more than once.
Once,
stop
I've been
it.
A muse before.
I've also been very amusing.
So let's go create that shirt. Because we want to create this shirt that we are going to give away, or that we're going to sell.
Yes.
We're going to sell in the very near future, coming up soon. We have told you about that. We will tell you about that soon.
Which is particularly important for us. The TREVOR Project is almost 100% privately funded through private donors
is
and
it?
Private foundations. Yeah.
Amazing.
So we don't get any government dollars, and so it this is going to be a tremendous
help. If you did before, you wouldn't now. But
okay, so what's the deal? What's our?
Well,
okay.
I thought okay. It would be really nice and romantic
what?
That we use the first photo of you and I together.
Yeah.
The first one that I
can find.
That I can find. It's the first one of my recollection.
Sure. Do we have that photo?
Yes, we got the photo.
Where is it?
Let's get it up on the screen, guys.
I want to see. Oh my gosh!
So, this is technically not the first one, because the first one you took, and I don't have. Because, as you know the story, maybe not everyone knows the story.
Right.
You first met me at a fan event that I was at.
Yes, I was. I've been a fan from the day one. I am still a fan. I'm a fan of all things wonderful, and Jeremy Scott is in that.
And
okay.
So that picture you took or someone took, your friend took. So, but this is when you had your record release at
and
Capitol.
You, that's right.
And you had wanted to this dress so badly.
This dress was an ice cream
yes.
cone.
You can kind of see, this is like a cone print, and then there's a tube of like ice cream.
Yes.
And so I remember you wanted it really badly and kept asking, you know, it was Johnny at the time,
yes.
kept asking our PR about it. And, you know, you were just starting, so there wasn't a big repertoire of who you were yet.
Right. You didn't know if you could trust me. You didn't know if I was going to run away.
Yes,
you didn't know if I was going to run away with that ice
cream. And so
cream.
The PR was kind of kept saying, I don't know. And then I was like, she loves this dress. Let this woman wear it. It means something to her. Who am I to stand in her way? And I was like,
I love you so
much. And I was like, it's an event down the street from my house. I'll go there. And
what?
I'll go.
I remember you came and you were like, you know, were the first person that like was like the celebrity to come, you know, and you were like, and it was like Jeremy Scott's here, and we were like, oh my God, Jeremy Scott's here. We were so excited.
And so then I stood on this and watched you perform. Oh wow. So I was like right there. This was me standing up here watching you perform out here at the very edge of the
parking
lot. And
I had an In-N-Out burger. There was proof that I've been eating it my whole life.
And so then at the end, you came all the way out to see me, and Mark Cobra Snake took this picture of us, bless his heart.
Aww, Mark Hunter.
And he's giving us permission for the picture to be, for us to use this,
aww.
For us to
sometimes this
do
works
this little
better
charity.
Better.
So yeah,
oh,
so that's
amazing.
The first
good.
Existing picture.
This is almost 9 years ago. We look
exactly.
good.
Exactly.
haven't aged a day. So what are we gonna do on top of it? Should we sign it? Should we do like a
yes.
little, I mean, I know you're an incredible artiste.
I mean, we can make a little frame for it.
Let's make a frame for it. I'm not a very good, you make the frame and I'm just gonna cut. You make the frame.
Frame it.
Wow. Yes. Yes!
We'll make a little plaque, like if it was in a fancy house.
And I'm gonna like just do, I know what I can do best. I'm gonna do some spiral or polka dots. Let's do polka dots. Big and small. Get out your paints, people. Pink polka dots.
Exactly. I'm gonna make our plaque gold.
Thank you. Would you like some water? Sit down, have a seat. I'm gonna drink my coffee so I can go all the way up.
Is this gonna go like all over the front of the t-shirt or is it in the back?
This is the front of the t-shirt because, well, that's right. Yeah,
right.
And this is where the picture will live.
We'll crop it in so we fit perfectly. Just some more little details.
Honestly, drawing is so therapeutic. You know they have those coloring books that are therapy books?
I've never seen them.
You've never seen them?
No.
They're for adults. Is that right?
They're adult coloring books, yeah.
They're adult coloring books.
We have them in our call centers.
Oh, really? I've always wanted one.
So that when counselors get off from a complicated call, sometimes they have a little self-care moment and they go over and kind of color.
That's the thing.
Self-care moment.
You know, that's the thing about it too, which we didn't really talk about, and that's what I was trying to say to Katy, is that, you know, there's also a lot of emotion and feelings that the people who are left after someone has you know, suicide, and there's a lot of guilt that survivors have, and that's something that you also, that's why, you know, you have to, you know, it's a lot of care all the way
around. Care, and for the helper too,
you know, of course.
So it can be really, it can take a lot out of you, and you've got that compassion that you can get fatigued from having all.
I don't think people realize how much energy can fatigue by transference of energy.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And people don't really realize that, but when you see a lot of people, when you're doing a concert or a show or things,
and you're an empath.
Yeah, you have a lot of. There's a lot of transference, and I get exhausted because I kind of lack the screens. Everyone's built kind of born with these screens.
Yeah.
And I
you
lack
don't
them.
Have, you lack this.
Because, and that's part of my gift. It's also part of my curse. That's why my work is so expressive.
By the way, you're right. Like, you're a pure person, and sometimes you, like, I've never seen you operate in an unpure way, truly. Like, I've seen you be a boss, and that's not something to be misunderstood. Like, you can be a boss, and you still can, and you can still, like, have boundaries, and you can still run something, and you can still, like, let someone go, but still operate out of integrity. I've never seen you not operate out of integrity, and I've always seen you hope the best for every single person that you've come in.
It's true.
Like, you literally hope the best for everyone. And that's hard sometimes, especially when people let you down, you know?
Yeah.
And when you just want the best and you think that everybody operates like a kind person.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of emotion with that.
Yeah.
And sometimes it comes later, too. So, for example, so a year ago was the shootings at the Pulse nightclub in Orlando.
Yeah.
And it happened the night before our gala in New York. So I was there, and what was fascinating was volunteers come flooding in. They're like, I have to be there to help. I have to do something. And, and so even as an administrator, you go into take care of everything mode.
Yes. Yeah.
And so it wasn't until an entire week had gone by where the impact of what actually had happened smacked me in the heart. And then I had my meltdown moment, but it was a week later. Like, I held on to it because I was so focused on taking care of all that.
Absolutely.
And a lot of, like, parents get like that. Like, where you just... It's sometimes like you get in bed at the end of the day and the things that happen to you during the day just come rushing in, and you have to take care of yourself.
It's true.
Or that energy you're carrying around will go on to somebody else too. Sometimes
it's like what Katy said a minute ago. It's like we take care of people, we'll go get a massage for their body, or there's all these other things, but we need to think about also the mind and the emotions. Mm-hmm. And it's true because mental health is so misunderstood. You know, I mean, also beyond all this, when we talk about the homeless epidemic and how much about that is mental illness. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when people have cancer, we all are very, like, quick to be able to understand it and feel bad. But when someone's acting erratic or, you know...
We ignore it.
Yeah. Or we laugh about it because it makes us uncomfortable. We don't have, as a society, we don't have the skill set taught to us. You know, people wouldn't laugh, like you said, if someone said, I have breast cancer. People wouldn't be like, you know. Like, whereas, like, if someone is, you know, I don't know, walks in without their pants on or something that is, like, alarming.
And by the way, like, you know, sometimes you do make a mistake and you do laugh about it, and I've done that. And, like, you know, it's not a laughing matter. And for anyone that knows what I'm talking about, you know, I'm sorry that I ever said anything about mental health, and I feel like I want to go on the record in saying that. I never want to take light of anything like that because, you know, I want the best for people. I want the best for all of my coworkers and all the people in entertainment, and even just like all the people I meet, everyone. I really want the best for them, and mental health is real.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
You know? And I know I just keep on saying it, but like, I see it happen in real time, and even like what you were just saying about like homelessness, like, it's so perplexing to me. It's not that sometimes people don't have the means. It's a real mental thing. And like I'm one of those people that say, I want to save the world. I want to help sure. save the world. But like, why don't I just start with like Homeboy Industries,
yeah.
you know, in downtown LA, or like, you know, why don't I just start with the homeless around the corner from
yes.
me? Like
yes.
literally take one turn
yeah.
in Los Angeles and it's right there. And yeah. you're like, wait, I came here 4 years ago and it wasn't there. And it's, what is that? What is that?
Yeah.
And it, and people are starting to say, that's, it's mental health.
Well, there too, so that, well, I.
You would know,
so please
much,
speak I'm sitting
on
here kind of like, there's
jump
so many things
in.
That you've said have been so powerful
jump
that really
in.
Kind of inspired me. So you might be surprised, I hope that you are shocked, to learn that 40% of homeless youth identify as LGBT.
40%?
40%. And the majority of those have either been kicked out of their homes or rejected by their families, or they have or they're actually refugees mm-hmm. fleeing an abusive household because
really?
Of their identities.
Yeah.
Among some other challenges as well. And but you were talking about when someone has a physical disease versus a mental health
sure.
complication, when someone has cancer or any
uh-huh.
other physical
uh-huh.
disease, you can blame the cancer. You can blame HIV. You can blame
sure.
all of these other things. But for mental health, people blame the people.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They believe it's just a choice or something you can snap out
yeah.
of.
Mm-hmm.
But can you imagine if we talked about cancer the way that we talk about mental health, and we're like, no, you're fine, just go to Six Flags and everything
yeah.
will be fine.
What?
You know, like, get over it, you'll
yeah.
be happy again. You'd be like, you're not making any sense.
Yeah.
We actually need treatment, we need help, we need access to
yeah.
care.
Telling
it's
someone that had
type.
Breast cancer to go to Six Flags, please.
Right. Well, so
like that's what it would be like.
But you can't say that to a depressed person either
yeah.
and say you're suffering with depression right now, so
yeah.
get over it. It doesn't work.
No.
Hopefully this gets a better rep, because as we now are in a time where we can talk about, let's say, alcoholism as a disease.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Which wasn't so, you know, and drug abuse.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Which not so long ago, it was in that category of it's your fault, instead of realizing that that person maybe has a chemical
yeah.
yes.
difference than another person who
yes.
doesn't have that
mm-hmm.
ability.
Yeah, you know, like
they're addicted.
Exactly.
Addiction is a disease.
It is a disease. And, you know, that's something that is so hopefully we can, as a society, move
yeah.
more forward to being able to talk about, you know,
yeah.
mental
like
illness in that way.
In Portugal, have you heard this story? What they did?
No.
So Portugal
tell us.
Has massive decrease in substance addiction and substance abuse problems.
Really?
Because
go Portugal.
They decriminalized, as far as I understand, almost every substance which here would be an illegal substance.
Sure.
So instead of putting people in jail or criminalizing them
yeah.
because of their use of, you know, recreational drugs, they actually poured all of that money instead of law enforcement into treatment and prevention, and they
that's
decreased
right.
substance abuse in the country by, I can't say a percentage
sure.
number, but
it's
hugely.
Treatment and prevention and rehabilitation.
Yeah.
Like with all of these things, like life is not a bed of roses, okay? We all go through these things, and we just need some help, some tools,
yeah.
like rehabilitation, like some answers to these questions that we have, because who writes the rule book? And if you got it, send it. Like, where is the rule book? You know what I'm saying? For today.
Should we just feel a responsibility to take care of people and take
yeah.
care of each other?
Yeah.
That should be the rule book.
That is the rule book, is the kindness that we can
yeah.
show to each other. It's a simple
empathy.
Rule.
Empathy,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I just feel like we need a couple more colors. I'm doing shapes.
I see.
It's like a little 80s, it's a little fun.
I'll add some triangles.
I'll add some spirals.
Sort of like a little Alice in Wonderland almost. It's
very 80s. Mm-hmm. I love you so much.
I love you too, my darling.
One last spiral.
Can never have too many.
Well, I think this is going to be a great frame to put on, what do you think, like a white t-shirt?
Yeah.
And then let the color pop in the center.
Yeah.
Is this our first collab? Like, kind of, like, officially.
I mean, yeah.
This is where we start.
Exactly.
This is where we start.
We've done so much, it's hard to say that.
I know, I've been a muse for Moschino, and...
Yes.
I'm sorry I missed the show, I love it so much.
Okay.
Well, thank you so much for coming by.
Thank you
for so much. We're gonna put our picture in here, and then, maybe, you want, let's, should we, like, just sign, we'll sign it down here. I'm gonna do this down here. And then maybe you can sign up for the Trevor Project.
Sure.
That'd be great. And what's the date today?
6/11.
6/11. It's like when you're living in this bubble, you're like, what day is it? What day is it today?
Aw, happy belated birthday!
Just put that in there.
That in there.
Everybody on the internet, say happy birthday, David.
It was funny because the staff came in, they're like, well, for your birthday, you get to go meet Katy Perry.
Aww.
I was like, all right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear David Bond. Happy birthday to you. Birthday cake cookies.
See? Prepared.
Dang.
She got her eye on everything.
You know me.
I have to give a shout out to Aya and all the great tracksuits every day. I love it.
Everybody thinks you're in your pajamas.
No, they're my tracksuits.
They're your tracksuits.
They think I'm in my pajamas, but I've been correcting them.
Good. You schooled them on that.
It's a Luke.
This is perfect. Amazing. Thanks for coming by. Happy Pride.
Thank you. Happy Pride.
And thank you for being such an incredible witness for people out there and being a light and using... You're a brilliant person.
You're a brilliant person. You're doing a really hard job. You know that. Give yourself compassion.
Well, thank you. I have to say... People walk up to me a lot and he's like, wow, you do such amazing work. I'm an administrator. The people who are doing the amazing work are our volunteer counselors and the people who answer the phone, the people who are taking those chats.
Yes.
And there are about 500 of them around the country. And okay, so well, those are the people.
If they see this or if they hear about this, we just want to say thank you so much.
Thank you
for your time. And we see you and we appreciate you and thank you for volunteering and you're doing incredible. You're basically an angel. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Love you. I'm gonna walk into the door. You guys.
Bye, pumpkin.
Love you too. Would also say if anyone's interested in volunteering for the Trevor Project, that whole process is through the website as well.
Absolutely. It's very easy. Just go to trevorproject.org.
The Trevor Project.
Excuse me. Don't forget about the T-H-E.
Right.
The Trevor Project.org.
Bye, Nugget.
I love you.
I love you more.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for coming by Witness Worldwide.
Hi.
Bye.
Love ya.
Jeremy is honestly one of the most genuine, kind-hearted human beings.
Doesn't have a bad bone in his body.
Yeah. And shout out to Whitney Fromholtz, my friend, who is one of those volunteers.
Whitney who?
Whitney Fromholtz.
Whitney Fromholtz.
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing.
Yeah. There is good in the world.
There is good in the world, and I know that a lot of you that are watching this are part of that good.
Mm-hmm.
I'm on the crack.
She on the crack. She on the crack. You want me to pull? Are you ready to rust?
What's that?
Rust.
Oh, yes, I'd like to. I'm going to change.
A change?
Yes, because I just want to be able to feel my diaphragm. The expansion.
Should we get your little steam cup thingy, weirdo thingy, alien?
It's not weird. It's from my voice, which is actually quite tired right now.
Yeah, I can imagine. It's you've been talking.
Yeah, and then like I screamed this morning.
Why?
Because I didn't want to eat the cow's tongue.
Oh yeah, that was disgusting.
I really screamed. I didn't want to do it.
You're good. Da da da. It comes off the bubble wrap.
I just want to be able to stretch and kick while I'm in that.
You got the shoes for it.
Sorry. You're like, what a freak.
Super freak. Super freak. A super freak, hey. Yeah, I could see you in it. Tamuru. I'm just going to follow you around with this mic because that's normal. Just like a, you know, a casual.
We need, gotta get you a boom.
I don't need no boom, I got a hand.
Hollywood.
Welcome to Hollywood.
Hollywood.
Holly weird.
Hollywood.
Is it really 6:10 p.m.? Sure is.
Sure is. We better get moving.
We got to get it going on.
When do I get to see my
guitar? Well, hopefully fairly soon.
Oh, those are beautiful.
Because
I just need to pick out what song I'm going to be singing.
Copy that.
Because I love
that. I pulled that one for you because I was like, oh, that would work.
Gamer.
Oh.
Give him.
Grammy.
We go.
off, but that originally wasn't the plan when I agreed to do the BBQ with you. But it's so hard to say like, no for me because I have extra dinner.
I'm getting used to it, quite honestly.
The most obscure one was?
What?
Was RuPaul this morning, though. What was that song?
Well, you guys don't happen to have any of this.
I think it was one of his. No, it was one he made up.
No. There was one by some guy who worked on your record, too.
Huh.
I don't remember the name. But I was like, wow, that's like a 90s throwback he just threw in there.
Well, he knows them. He's got all that knowledge.
Sure does.
Okay.
I feel like I'm cradling a tiny warm baby. Okay, we're heading over. Oh, someone's doing a little stretchy stretch.
I don't know.
No.
The internet will tell me.
Yeah, no, it's definitely not Japanese.
Is it fun, though?
I like that a lot.
That's my favorite one so far. Actually, no, that's not true. Your weird green alien one was.
Yeah. Can you grab my coffee, please?
Yeah.
What do you think?
It looks so, no fun. Sorry, but it looks real good. I almost feel like you have to...
Oh.
Yeah.
So cool.
It's so crazy, the optical illusion. You know what works really well on this?
What?
Boomerang, where you jump from one to the other.
Yeah, that's what they were doing earlier,
But we shall save that. Tams, can you grab that and I'm gonna grab a coffee?
Hi guys.
Hi.
Are we used to this yet? Hi guys. Go crazy. Hi guys.
What's up? Good timing.
Production.
What?
May we please get a cleaning crew in here to help in the kitchen?
What's up? How's it going?
What have you been up to?
You look great in there.
Josh, have you been watching me?
Sleeping
what?
Yoga-ing or something? Like dog.
Is there a lot of dog shots? Are there a lot of dog shots?
Yeah, there's a dog solo for a while.
Oh yeah, it's like a slow zoom in on that little miniature thing.
What is
those little Korean dog cams called?
Puppy dog, puppy cam.
Yeah, something like that.
What is it like in the outside world?
We've been here too.
No, I know.
Sleeping right here.
I know.
This is my favorite.
What is?
This outfit.
Oh, hers. Yeah. Girl. I was like,
spin.
Thank. I was like, fine.
I mean, every day
we're just
killing it.
Was it cute?
I can scooch over here on a little poof.
Oh,
it's not as poofy as I thought it was.
Mod spot for sure.
Very cute.
We're watching you. Your makeup.
Patrick killed it.
Basically, we're stopping.
I watch him. I've watched him too, though.
Like, lurking all day.
I watch him too.
Right?
His YouTube is
amazing. It's like you can learn how to do any of it.
Where I learned.
Is that how you learn?
I learned from Candy, I learned from him, I learned from all of them.
Really?
That's who taught me, girl. YouTube taught me.
YouTube taught me! Okay, so here's the truth of the matter is. I've been doing a lot of talking. I'm tired. So I'm not going to do a lot of singing. I want to do a little bit of listening so we can make notes for Monday. Our show on Monday, people are still winning tickets every hour, right?
Sure.
You go to, if you want to win tickets, if you want to come see the show that we're playing tomorrow, you can win tickets by going to www.kpsweepstakes.com. And we're giving two tickets away each hour, on the hour, 24 hours. Wild, wild, wild. Very excited. We're going to do a little bit of rehearsing right now. I basically want to listen to the new songs because I would love to make some constructive criticism notes.
Where's the
tab? Yeah, let me get my ears. I'm not going to go full blown today on the vocal. I should save pace. Hiya.
Hi.
Are they transitioning in there?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's happening.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. I believe you. Because I want to hear like what it would sound like in my ears, you know? Like what it'll sound like in the outside world. Man, I sit there.
Oh, you're coming over.
Don't worry.
What you got for me today, girl? She owns you, Debbie
Jarkey.
She likes
okay.
This is the proposed set list.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time we're done here, give us your thoughts.
How many songs is that?
This, you know, that's a medley, so.
Oh, right.
You know, so.
That's a good medley.
Yeah.
So it's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And it's probably 45?
To an hour.
Oh, 45
to an
hour.
It's really open. It's whatever you want to do.
Right. That's great.
Yeah. So you can, if you're, you know, more or less.
If the vocal is willing.
Yeah. Huh?
Mm-hmm. How are you guys doing?
Awesome.
Good? Good? Okay, cool. Let's listen to Hey, Hey, Hey. I'm just going to listen and just maybe think about some of just some changes or whatever it is.
Yeah, cool. Okay, that's good.
You could take my vocal out. That's what she does. She came and grabbed your beef jerky.
She did.
Okay.
Yeah.
cause I'm so resilient. LOL at all your madness. I'm making millions.
If I can be seven, I can be the storm, yeah. Smell like the rose in my ears like the thorn, yeah. Your body juggling the dishes and norms. All in a dream.
Yeah, just so, because it seems a little high, maybe we can have a little tone to anchor it, please.
So that makes a great opener.
Does it?
It does. It's cool. Yeah.
Really?
It could. Yeah.
For tour.
Maybe.
Great. We don't need to hear the medley because we heard that, right?
Yeah, done plenty.
And it's the same medley we've been doing, right?
Yeah, same medley.
Okay.
And as far as this goes, figure out what you want to do about that. We want to do the, which intro we want to do.
What's that, in the change of the rhythm?
Mm-hmm.
I want to do the one that I've been doing.
Yeah.
Let's rehearse that really quickly.
Cool. So change.
Just the intro, you know?
Intro. With the remix on the back, we do, right?
Yeah.
Cool.
Comfortable. Aren't you lonely up there in utopia, where nothing will ever be enough? Happily now. So comfortable we're living in a bubble. So comfortable we cannot see the trouble. Glasses on and party on. this room is so hard. This room is like a cement box. I know, and I feel it. This is like, there's no beautiful bounce anywhere. It's just like the sound sticks right here. There's no reverb. You know what? And people are not going to understand. Let me break it down. The reason why we like to go into our bathrooms to sing is because, I don't know what it is, the tile? Yeah. The bathrooms are like the best place to sing. The shower is the best place to sing. It's all that tile. It makes it all sound like you're like singing in the Notre Dame, you know, like it really feels like you're singing in this like big, beautiful acoustic place. And the difference is like if you're singing in like a box, like a concrete box, it's just like, whoa. You have to kind of push even a little bit harder to get the note, to get the sound to fly more. Because it just, there's so much resistance. Okay. No more zhuzh, because I'm hearing a lot of it in my ears, but I think, you know, it'll be totally different tomorrow. Okay, let's do Save as Draft. Let's hear it. Oh, I got it.
Good. I remember when you used to be my every other thought. Calendar's so full, it's easier to move on. Turn up on my bomb, bulletproof. I don't mess with change, but lately I've been flipping coins alive. You don't have to step to me, my number's always been the same.
Love that. That's a nice snare. Ooh, give it to me. Give me that whip. Give me that whip. Hey, hey. I will always be. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean. It's like the width of the snare. Woo! Girl. Every time. Let sleeping dogs fly. Let's hear Swish.
Swish.
Oh, we're not playing Tsunami.
They know what is what, but they don't know what is what. They just strut. What the f-
Don't need opinions from a shellfish or a sheep. Don't you come for me. Oh, not today.
I mean, I don't know why, maybe, you know when you're tired?
Yeah.
Everything seems faster, sonic-wise. Yeah. So I might just be tired, because I'm like, this is so slow.
Yeah. And this room is...
It's just this room. Not giving us anything. Okay, let's do the chorus. I don't need to hear the whole thing, I just wanted to, like, get used to it anyways.
Cool. Would you do from chorus two?
Yeah. Course two, course two.
Swish, swish, fish. Another one in the basket.
It's just a little bit of a longer. It's like by a milla.
Cool.
Yeah. Okay. Great. Let's go for it.
Go for it, Tony. Go for it. Just go for it. Just give it to us.
Whoa, that was like some extra, too. I felt that. Okay. Okay. Just those extras. He is so extra. He is so extra.
It is. Put it all that on you. Talk control.
Track. background vocals as well. A little bit in my ears, please. I'm found her.
Kacey, will you just play the sound? No, play. Go back to on power, where it just goes boop 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 boop.
Tell your computer.
So this is a sound. This is a sound I feel like when I'm playing Super Mario. On Nintendo 64, when I'm growing, when I caught that star.
You eat the mushroom.
Or I eat the mushroom. Here I, ready? Go. Boop, 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 boop. And when you guys do it together, will you do it for me? Oh, you have to take your computer back too. Computers. Computers. Ready? It's like we're growing. Okay, sorry. I just can't get over Butters right now, looking like a human. Is she? Why?
Twitching.
Okay, well, let's do Witness and let's finish with that. Oh, yeah, no, we need to do Bon Appetit.
Okay. Instead of or just edit it?
I don't know, I'm going to have to make that call, but let's...
I'll put it in there somewhere.
Let's listen to it. I'm going to sit and listen to it, actually.
Oh?
Yeah.
Minus our friends.
See.
That's good.
Are we still having that thing about computer versus real life? Timing wise?
Fresh out the oven, melting your mouth, kind of loving. Bon appetit, baby.
Yeah, it's great. You guys sound great. It's like... Sometimes it's a challenge when you make lots of sounds with computers to bring them to life. Mm-hmm. It's a real challenge. Okay, let's do Witness. Mm-hmm. Please. Okay, say go. Sing to me. Speak to me with your good tone. Let it, yes, ripple effect.
If I lost it all today, would you stay? Could my love be enough to stimulate? If the fan grenades got thrown, would you? Could you go down with me? Could we get
Let's wet this vocal up even a little bit more on this on the verses. Stay in the flow. No.
Thank you guys so much. Cool. Sounds good. I like it.
So where that falls in the set?
What are you eating? Thank you, Dave. Butters, drop it. Hey, drop it. It's an almond.
Uh-oh. It's gone.
How did you buy the almond?
I don't know.
So you think here or here?
What?
Where should it go in the set? Ish. That?
Oh, and went back to
five.
We
got
another one. What is it?
That's from
one of
the
set.
What is
it?
Somebody just.
No, we put our
there.
It's definitely not after Swish.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah.
I think power and then. I think these two are come right here. We end with that. Maybe?
I'm into that.
Okay.
That's cool. Cool.
Or actually.
Yeah. Because that's like the only song that can follow that.
I agree. Yeah, I agree. And this is a nice, vocally, this is a nice little moment you've got here to gear up for this stuff.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Sounds really good. And I'll put some of the others as alternates on the bottom so you can see them in case you're
okay.
Wild.
Hey, Katie?
Yes.
Two questions. Are these yours? Are you missing a pair of your voice?
I don't know.
Second question, what do you want to do for a microphone for tomorrow?
Metallic. Metallic, silver.
Metallic, like a chrome.
Silver. Chrome, yes,
gotcha.
Please.
Gotcha, okay. We'll do.
Thanks, guys. Have a great rest of your day.
You too.
Thank you. Thank you so much for coming in. Thank you.
I loved the dinner last night.
Did you?
Yeah, it was nice. Awesome.
Good. I'm glad. Thank
who's
you.
Lady who, the Native American woman?
Heather. Heather,
she was, like,
I mean, she's...
blowing my mind.
I heard her speak one time before that, and I was like... Yeah. Whoa, truth talker.
Yeah.
Truth talker. She's amazing. Heather, I want to say Mills, not Mills. I'm not sure. But anyways, she's amazing.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think her name is
on my social media. Just, thanks, guys. Thanks, Toby. Had
what
is any of those surprise boxes?
Yeah, because we've been running and running and running and running and running. So
it's just the rest of the world.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, I'm ready.
He is ready,
to
ready
laugh.
For you.
Where?
In the confessional.
Do
you need a moment?
No, I'm happy.
Okay.
I'm so happy. Are we an hour behind?
We are like 2.5.
Mmm. Mmm. Okay.
Oh, wait, he's gonna come through the door.
Time is a construct.
Go ahead.
But I'm late. Okay, I'm
says
late.
Who?
I know. Can we delay the dinner by an hour?
Yeah.
Or less.
Right now it's 8:30. You want us to push to 9:30?
No, just by 9.
To 9?
Yeah.
Okay.
Please.
Copy, copy.
I'll try and make up the time.
Okay.
Make
did
up
you hear
the
that,
hours.
Guys?
Oh,
perfect.
Kind,
yes,
thank you so much. What is this? That,
Can I get a witness?
Did you taste it? Have you tasted it?
Yeah.
I don't want to taste it.
I'm so happy. We are late.
Can I get a
Lady
witness?
Perry in the house. I'm always late.
Can I get
are you
a witness?
My muffin?
She's so tired.
Well, can you imagine what her mother feels like? You know.
Can I get a witness?
I have got a
yeah.
date. Michael?
Katie
Perry. How are you?
I'm well. How are
I
you?
Am sorry for being tardy, but I'm here.
I understand.
It's a big thing you've got going on here.
No, it is a small thing. We're just here at the house talking.
Uh-huh.
How are you, Michael?
I'm well, but more importantly, how are you?
I'm well, thank you. How's your Sunday going so far?
Uneventful, less eventful than yours.
Okay, well, we're gonna make it more eventful. Everybody, this is Michael Ian Black. He
Hi.
Is here. He has a really
Hi.
Interesting, amazing, funny podcast.
Sure.
It's called How to Be Amazing.
And you're gonna be my guest.
And I'm gonna be the guest. So we're gonna go into the confessional. I'm gonna take a quick little potty. Will you help me,
yeah.
Aya, please? And we are gonna talk about how to be amazing. Which is kind of sarcastic, correct?
No, because from my point of view, the people that I have on are amazing.
Oh, okay, well, that's
and
good.
And so, you count.
Cheer, cheer, cheer.
Absolutely in count.
Michael, can I get you a glass of water?
Sparkling water?
Oh, some water would be fantastic.
Kombucha.
Oh, is that Nugget?
A
yeah.
cat, a cat, a dog.
Hi. Sweetheart. Wow.
She's funny, huh?
Flat water, sparkling?
Yeah, yeah, flat's fine.
Flat? Okay.
Thank you.
I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Where are you coming from? Oh my gosh, wait, hold on.
Michael, just a glass of water.
Before we start.
Yeah.
You're in Wet Hot American Summer.
I am in Wet Hot American Summer. Do you love Wet Hot American Summer?
It's a cult following. You know it's a cult following.
Well, I know that it's got a big audience.
Well, it's okay. It's I saw it maybe twice. I loved it.
Oh, you did?
It was amazing. Yeah. It was hilarious. It's like my cup of tea humor.
Well, thank you.
Okay, can you just mute my mic because I'm going to potty?
Agua.
Thank you so much.
No worries.
What's your name?
I'm Aya.
Hi, Aya. Michael.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
welcome,
you.
Welcome, welcome.
Now, is Nugget just snuggled in the jacket, or is Nugget
No, she's just in my jacket.
A baby Bjorn.
I wish she was in a baby Bjorn.
How old is Nugget?
She's 2. It's her birthday next month. Huh, Nuggie? Yeah. I think she's like we are. We've hit that wall, you know? We're like...
Yeah, you guys are exhausted.
Yeah. Yeah. But we're going to power through.
Yeah.
She hasn't had coffee in a while, so this is like full crack moment.
Oh, I thought you meant Nugget hadn't had coffee in a while.
She
it's
hasn't
like the dog
either.
Drinks coffee.
Yeah. She likes a latte in the morning, but she's been off lately, so we'll be right back.
This is what.
Help with this?
No, I just had them mute it, or people just heard me pee.
Awesome.
I don't know.
That's full access.
If they did hear me pee, congratulations. Hooray for you.
We all do it.
Hooray for you if you heard me pee.
In Japan, they play music, so you don't
that's
have
correct.
To hear it pee. We should have done that. We should have played the Witness album every time you peed.
Cool. Awesome.
Are you all set?
Yes, sir.
How old are you closing the
children?
16 and 14.
What?
I know, old, right?
You look barely born.
I'm just a wee lad.
16, 14? Have I met you before, Ian? Michael?
No.
Ian?
I don't think so.
Maybe it's just because I've seen the movie and stuff.
Perhaps.
Perhaps.
All right, are you ready?
I am ready, spaghetti. Thank you so much.
I'm going to do a short introduction.
Okay, fantastic.
And then we'll be off and running.
I can't believe I'm 14 and 16. That's amazing. Anyways, go ahead.
All right. It's How to Be Amazing. I'm Michael Ian Black. A lot of what I talk about on this show is creative struggle. And the journey towards creative expression. And most people, I say, are able to have that struggle in a personal way and in an anonymous way. How is that journey different when you are one of the most famous people in the world? How do you navigate the desire to explore different parts of yourself with the demands placed upon you and the demands you placed upon yourself to maintain your position in the culture? You may have just heard my guest's dog barking in the background. And there she is again. He or she?
She.
My guest today can perhaps shed some light on the subject of living a creative life in public. Rolling Stone called Katy Perry one of our generation's indisputable hitmakers.
You're trying to call me beautiful.
Rolling Stone called my guest one of our generation's beautiful hitmakers. Over the last 10 years, she's had 9 number one hits, sold millions of albums, racked up billions of video views, and is the most followed person on Twitter. She's described her new album, Witness, as a declaration of political, sexual, and personal liberation. And I'm very happy to welcome Katy Perry to How to Be Amazing. Hello.
Hello, Michael. Thank you so much for having me. What an intro. Well, I feel like I could never just fall. I just don't even know. I feel like I should quit now.
Well, it was apt, though. I mean, I didn't say anything that wasn't true.
That's absolutely true. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, and thank you for being a part of this show. Now, let me start with the where we are. We're broadcasting.
Because someone heard some dogs, right?
Well, yes, there
You'd
were
imagine
dogs.
That maybe I was at my home.
You might imagine that, and then unbeknownst to the listeners, Katy Perry was shushing other voices that are occurring.
I was just politely saying, can you keep it down so we can have
You were polite. I did not mean to imply that you were anything but polite.
A shush.
But we're recording this in what is called the confessional. And the confessional is a built room within a built Katy Perry household within a larger theater.
Yes.
All of which is being live streamed to the world over a period of 3 days?
About 3.5.
About 3 days. And then all of that is surrounded by the various apparatus that occur around any production. And in the center of it is Katy Perry. And I wonder...
The eye of the storm that she created.
Well, that's what I wonder about. You create this storm.
Yes.
Do you ever feel lost in the storm?
Yes, I have in the past, most definitely. And what he's referring to, for all of those that you haven't seen it or have no idea what he's talking is, I started this, I created this idea called Witness Worldwide, and I partnered up with YouTube for a never been done before live stream, a bit like The Truman Show and Big Brother, which I'm big fans of. And I've watched Truman Show several times, and sometimes I would say to myself, am I living in that world? And then when like someone like Elon Musk says, we're living in a simulation, I'm like, are we all living in that world? What is this? And my mind spirals out of control.
And so you think, if we're not living in the simulation, let me create it to see what that would be like.
Let me create the simulation and also give you a taste as to how I live my life and how great and normal and mundane and boring it all is. All the good, bad, and ugly and everything in between.
Well, but let me interject, because there's nothing particularly, from my observations, normal about what I'm observing, because we're surrounded by robot cameras.
This is correct.
And we're in this...
Also known as everywhere.
Well, I guess so. I guess that's true. And this environment isn't your environment. I mean, it's a
facade.
It's a facade. Yes. And it seems like so much of what you're playing with right now and trying to figure out,
yes,
is what is Katy Perry?
Yes.
What is... Katy Hudson.
What is this creature?
What is this creature known as Katy Perry versus what is Katy Hudson?
Yes.
That's your given name.
Yes.
And can you, where does that struggle come from? And is that a new struggle for you?
No, it's all, you know, it's been a bit of a constant struggle, but sometimes the volume gets louder and louder and that somewhat you can't ignore it because... we all want to be who we're born as, I guess, or who we feel most authentic. And I love this, you know, personality, this exaggerated personality version of myself, this character that I created on stage called Katy Perry. And that worked out really well for me. I got to play the Super Bowl. I got to do Outdream My Dreams. I mean, lots and lots
you
of stuff.
You did a Maybelline, a CoverGirl commercial.
I've done several.
I just saw a CoverGirl commercial when I was trying to live stream this.
Oh, really?
It showed me your commercial before
yes,
this.
Yes, you know, there is an operation going on,
there
as
is
you
an
can
operation.
Imagine. I've been blessed with all these wonderful things that I've created. But at the core of it, you know, my birth certificate says Katherine Hudson. And that's really kind of like who I am. And I didn't really know who that was. And I always thought maybe that person wasn't enough or wasn't pretty enough. And, you know, so like I created a more exaggerated version of her so that I could you know, do my thing. But I think like the more authenticity that I show, which has been my journey, I think people start to realize that like, I'm just really Katy Hudson, and then they can have the same dream. And I've been saying this is that like if they can see any little part from like the way that I like clean my ears with a Q-tip or like brush my teeth or like because I talk in my sleep, some people say, or what have you, if they can kind of see themselves in it, then they can realize maybe they too can find their purpose and talent and dream as big as I did.
Something that you're talking about right now I find really interesting, which is it's a question about pop stars, and in particular, female pop stars,
yeah,
of the last, let's say, 10, 15, 20 years,
yeah,
where it seems like, do you want to get some coffee? I saw you looking at the coffee.
No, go ahead.
It seems...
It's my first coffee in a long time, and I'm like kind of tripping.
Don't trip too hard on
okay,
the coffee.
I'm gonna go.
It seems like pop stars, or the job of pop star now comes with a certain level of responsibility towards your fans. Do you feel that responsibility?
Well, you don't have to take on that responsibility, but I guess I choose to in a way that, like, yeah, I want to be an example. I want to be a good example, but I definitely can't be put on the pedestal of perfection because I'm a human, and I will fail. And that's the thing is, like, I make a lot of mistakes, and I live under a microscope, and a lot of people come for me, and I'm like, okay, well, I'll look at that. Then maybe I didn't have all the information. A lot of times I don't have all the information because, you know, juggling 7,000 bottles under a microscope, you're bound to like lose a couple of them along the way. And sometimes I'm misinformed, and sometimes I just put my foot in my mouth, or sometimes, you know, bad judgment or ego takes over. But
I'm glad I never make mistakes.
You know what, Michael, you don't sound like the kind of guy that does. But I think that it's actually a really good example of being able to fall and get back up again.
So then it seems like it would be very comfortable to be that person who it kind of finds this thing, that they, and I'm just going to loosely describe this as the kind of Katy Perry sound and the Katy Perry persona and the Katy Perry person. Mm. And yet it seems like, as evidenced by what your statements about this record, mm-hmm. that you're trying to evolve in political ways, in personal ways, in sexual ways.
Mm-hmm. Not just based on, like, you know, media or marketing or what have you, like real personal ways. And I think...
So did something spur that? Was there a moment? Or was it just...
It was a series of moments. It was a domino effect, I think, honestly. We did, like, this domino trick, and I was like, oh, that feels like a lot like my life, like one big domino after another. But I do think, and I want to go back to, you know, I do think, and I'm not saying, oh, poor us or anything, but I think women in general, you know, they have this idea of, like, perfection and pop stars, and, like, we can't go out there without makeup, and, you know, everything has to be luxurious or glamorous or perfect. And I really wanted to try in my own way to kind of break down that stereotype that, like, women
Let it be noted for the record, though, you're very made up right now.
I sure am, but also... It doesn't mean that I can't play, and that's my choice. But I also have a choice to do, like, to take my makeup in front of this mirror that I have upstairs.
What you're saying is I should have put on makeup.
No, I'm saying it's all up to you. Whatever makes you feel good about yourself, makeup is a great tool to highlight what you already have and to transform and be a chameleon. But you don't have to live under this kind of, like, guideline that you have to look a certain way or be a certain weight or have a certain haircut or so forth, I guess. And I think, you know, I think a lot of pop stars are really trying. They're scared of, like, you know, maybe some of them don't feel like they're enough, because a lot of artists become artists because they want to find this character, or they have to, like, transform into a different person because of, like, a protection mechanism.
And do you know where that comes from for you?
For me, childhood trauma. So I went through some childhood trauma, and that led to me not feeling like I was enough. Or that I was anything special, or that I was pretty enough. Like, I always remember, like, looking at magazines and truly looking at them and being like, oh, I just want my life like that, and not knowing that these are, like, photo shoots and, like, you know, this is all rentals and, like, it's just a tableau, basically. Mm-hmm. It's not real life. And yeah, a lot of what everyone's seeing in Witness Worldwide is not real life, and it's a bit heightened, but, you know, at the core of it, they're seeing, like, a real person having a real experience. And so I thought, okay, well, I'm gonna live in this fantasy world. I'm gonna make believe this person. And I found my little talent at 9 years old, and I realized it resonated with people. And so I started kind of accessorizing that talent and, like, finding out costumes and things like that, and living in a real fantasy land that I created, and kind of forgetting about, you know, Katy Hudson.
And were you living in that fantasy land? Were you sort of putting on blinders to the rest of the world? Were you cognizant of it?
I was trying to escape.
Right.
I was just trying to escape.
And what was it you were trying to escape exactly?
Escape the feelings of pain.
Yeah.
You know, escape just this pain that I had, that I was living with, and I didn't know how to face it. I was too young. I didn't have the tools. And it took 31 years to get to that place. And, like, it's been an incredible journey, and I love everything and don't dismiss where I come from or what I've done. And it's, you know, if you look at the graph of my life, it's up and down, up and down, and it will continue to be. Like, in my career, I will have things that are unsuccessful, and they won't always be positive, and they won't always be negative, and not everybody is going to say nice things, and not everyone's going to praise the music, and it's always going to be a combination of both things. But I've learned now that those negative, you know, those low points, those negative points aren't going to take me out completely. Like, those negative things that aren't going to take me out, because I know...
When you say take you out,
yeah.
What does that mean to you?
Kill me. You know what I'm saying?
You mean, like, literally,
yeah,
end you?
End me, you know, or end my career. I think that now I have the tools, and I have a group of friends that I can lean on, and people that I trust, and I think, you know, I know how to communicate better It was very hard to communicate feelings because I didn't really grow up talking about feelings.
But that's interesting coming from somebody whose job it is to express feelings. I mean, that's literally your job.
Well, yeah, I guess it's my, like, that's the only way I know how to, but in real life and like everyday situations, you know, in singing, I can do that, you know.
Were you unable to be confrontational? Could you like have a confrontation with somebody in a healthy way?
No, it's just I wasn't able to speak for myself. Like, I would put people first so much so sometimes, and then I would, like, not have any resources. And then also, I just, like, you know, sometimes people that are really narcissistic, they can prey upon empath people, and, like, I just kind of crumble in that regard. Or I have in the past.
So, when you say that you weren't able to communicate or
speak up.
It seems like,
and it's funny because I write all the songs about speaking up.
Yeah,
but those songs really, I'm not writing them typically for anyone else. They become everyone else's anthems, but I'm literally.
But they're like reminders to yourself.
They're tiny reminders. I was like, come on, they're reminders to me.
But how does somebody, and when I say somebody, you, how do you go from becoming pop singer to pop superstar without taking control of that
inner person?
Not only that inner person, but that outer person. I mean, it seems like you would have
to
be able to stand up.
By the way, I'm in control of that outer person, you know, the Katy Perry. Like, I run my ship, and I've got an incredible team and a bunch of sailors, and, you know, they all report to me, or, like, it all comes from me.
Do they salute? You should make them salute.
No, I'm definitely not. I just use it as a metaphor.
I love the idea of sailors.
Sailors.
On the ship.
On the ship. And it's not the Titanic. But I am the person that runs the whole operation, and for a long time, you know, people...
So you could separate sort of the confident business Katy,
yes,
was there and present and running the ship,
gosh,
and the personal Katy. Yeah,
but there's a lot of people that are really high up. I mean, look at, it's kind of a tale as old as time in business, in huge industries, that like their personal life just crumbles.
Yeah.
Because they just don't know, you know, they don't know how to have it all or what have you, or they don't know what true intimacy looks like, because they just know how to win, which is great, great, great. But like when you're at the top of the mountain and you're all by yourself and you're like looking down, you're like, I feel like SH.
Right.
You're like, okay, well, what does this really mean? You know, like.
And did you, have you found that answer for yourself? I mean,
yeah.
I don't know that.
I know that answer for myself now.
What is it?
It's loving yourself.
Yeah.
I didn't love myself. I didn't know how to love myself. And kind of put myself first. I know it just sounds like a bunch of hippie BS, but it's so true. Like taking time for yourself and learning how to nurture yourself and learning how to like really take care of yourself, like mental health.
Yesterday, we're recording this on day 2.5 or day 3 of whatever this is you had.
I don't even know what day of the week it is. I'm just in this room.
For the record, it's a Sunday. Last night.
Thank God.
You had an emotional on-camera therapy session. That was two nights. I think it was last. Two nights ago?
It's all a blur.
All right, whatever. With Dr. Siri Satnam Singh. And in that session, this just goes along with what you're saying.
Absolutely.
You said you can be right or you can be loved. And it occurred to me that those two things aren't necessarily in conflict. And I was wondering what you meant by it.
Well...
And I was wondering actually what you even meant by being right.
Okay, so... For instance... you know, truth comes in a lot of different forms. And that's the word truth is a lot of different definitions for people. Sometimes the word truth is, you know, science. Sometimes that word truth.
I'm going to call that objective truth, empirical truth.
Okay, or math.
Sure.
Truth.
I'm going to call that math truth.
Okay, all right. Compartmentalize it however which way you want. And then, you know, there's truth about beliefs and things like that in belief systems and or constructs, you know, that were created for whatever reason that they were created. And that is, you know, a lot of people live by these quote-unquote truths. And so, and some of them are, a lot of them are really important, not even just out of some of them. And I'm a person of faith that believes in God and all of those things. And I've been talking about it this weekend. But it's sometimes difficult to have a conversation with people when some people believe one version of truth and one people believe in the other version. And we're witnessing that every day now. It's just like, what is real truth? And I think a lot of us are just talking at. There's a lot of at talking.
Talking at, A-T, meaning yes. talking past each other talking as opposed to each other.
Yeah, not
or
with
each other, yes.
There's not a lot of with here. And I realized that, especially when my bubble burst, and you know, my parents have a different set of views, political and religious views, that some of them I don't really agree with, based on whatever my truth is, which is different. And I was just like thinking to myself, wait, in this whole thing, am I going to lose my family? Am I not going to be able to sit at the dinner table?
When you say this whole thing, what do you mean? Do you mean
that? I mean the political climate, you know, how separated we feel, because I feel really separated, and how everybody's just like trying to be right, you know? And I'm not saying that there are some obvious things that are right and some obvious things that are wrong, but I feel like...
So how do you navigate it when...
I listen. Right. So I listen, and I try and have patience, and I feel like, and I don't know if I'm just a full-on optimist, but I feel like at the core of everyone wants the best for each other. We want to be kind to each other. I want your family and your children to be amazing. How to be amazing. Your family, I want the best for your family. I don't even know that. I want those kids to grow up and be beautiful children. And I don't even know
them.
It's
too late.
It's too late. Okay, right. Yeah, they're in their teens. They're like, whatever. Whatever. But I do want the best for people. And I think that we all have that. Like, we're all born with that. And sometimes, you know, that feeling gets corrupted or perverted or it gets... we abandon that feeling, but I think that more now than ever, I think my job is to listen, to learn, to help people feel seen and heard, because a lot of people do not feel seen and heard. People feel like they do not exist. And even with the exercise with my parents, like, you know, it's difficult sometimes to have the conversation, but we learn so much together once we have that conversation.
You talked about, well, you brought up your parents, and for my listeners who don't know, Katy was brought up by two pastors. They still minister.
Yes.
And started in...
So that's what it meant, to be either right or loved.
Got it.
Yes.
Thank you, because I think that's a great moment. Wait, who's that dog?
That's Butters.
Okay, so there's another dog that just came in that isn't your dog named Butters. That's also a cute dog.
Thank you.
So you were brought up with faith, and at what point did you start to feel like that faith that you held as a child and through your childhood wasn't enough, or it wasn't the correct faith for you? Not in terms of it being a
right or wrong faith. Yeah, I think the right word is for me.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that... I came out the womb going, hold up!
You came out questioning.
I came out questioning.
You came out a Jew, is what you said.
I came out curious. I have been curious from day one. And I think that I'm just like naturally more, I'm really interested in facts and science and biology and the unknown and space. And like we had Neil deGrasse Tyson on here, and I was like, whoa, you know, those are kind of my heroes. Those are really like, I'm like, no, those are my true heroes. Those people that can really tell you about the unknown in some ways that simply can tell you about it. And how the way the world works, I'm really interested in history. I'm really interested in like how we got here, what we did, all those things, you know, because I think you can really learn from history and hopefully not repeat it. But I've been questioning, I've just been like, you know, some of my favorite people are like Socrates and Pluto and those guys, like the ones that ask so many questions.
Did this, you said, you came to LA when you were 17, and it seems like that by necessity and to pursue this mm-hmm. passion mm-hmm. would necessitate sort of skipping a lot of the formal education that it sounds like you're kind of craving now.
This is my formal education.
And so is it ever intimidating to be 32 and going, I don't know this, and I don't know this, and I don't know this? Or are you comfortable with that? And the reason I ask is because I'm not really even asking about you so much as I'm asking about for listeners like or people like myself who don't know anything or don't feel like they know anything, but sometimes feel like the world knows so much more than they do that they're intimidated to ask and intimidated to say, I have no idea what you're talking about. Can you explain to me?
Like, I think the place that you start is having a little compassion for yourself. And it's amazing that you can even recognize that you want to know and that, you know, you don't want to feel bad about wanting to know. And I think you can just ask yourself, like, when this is my little exercise I've done pretty much my whole life is why, just asking what that word means. Like, just stopping in conversation saying, what does that word mean? Because there's a lot of words that people use, and that's how you learn, and language is amazing. Or how do you spell it? And not having shame. And that's the thing is, like, I'm 32, and my education will go on for the rest of my life. And I hope I never know everything. I really, that means, like, something is not working if I know everything. And the more that I do know, the more I realize I don't know. But the fact of the matter is that, like, I really hope in this kind of space that I've created is that we can take the shame away from being curious, the shame away from asking
questions.
Do you feel
like there's a shame in curiosity?
I think people are like, yeah, well, either you have an Ivy League college degree or you don't. And if you don't have a college degree, then you can't speak.
Right.
And you know what? That's a privilege. A college degree is a privilege, you know? And I know I have so many privileges already, even just by my birth. And I just think that, like, we have to create a safe place for people to ask questions and to try because, first and foremost, I don't think that the internet can be the safest place to do that. I think it's.
I disagree. The internet is the safest place ever to do everything.
Ever. I guess maybe I'm lobbying for a kinder place. And I know that, like, all these things quite possibly were created with good intentions and for curious minds, and they are the new libraries, and we should lean into that. But I think that, like, we should have compassion for people, and instead of, like, you know, last night, some of the people were saying, instead of saying, you're done, or you're canceled, or snapping at people, like, instead of publicly doing that, just, like, send them a DM, you know what I'm saying? Or, like, try and, like, you know, give the information, send a link. Here's the information. If you want to know more about this thing, you know, maybe you didn't get it right because you didn't have the information.
So you're sensing, I'm just rephrasing your words to see if I understand you. You're sensing that it's more important for people in the online space and maybe it's carrying over into the offline space.
Oh, it's a bleeding. People don't.
And it's that sense of, I need to be right. That's what we were just talking about. As opposed to, I want you to understand me a little bit better, and here's how to understand
Right. And the truth of the matter is there are two different worlds here that we're working in. We're working in the real world, and then there's the internet. And that world, truthfully, is not real. It's really not real. Like, can you drop a pin on the internet? Like, where is the internet? Can you visit it?
Yeah, it's in a server farm somewhere in the Midwest.
Okay, all right. Can you touch it? No, that's the thing. It's like, it's this thing that we've all created. In a way, it's kind of like a construct. You know, we've created it. And, like, I think that look, I sleep by my phone. You know, I wake up to it. I say, hello, I love you. You know, and I have almost 100 million people on Twitter. So please, like, when I send a tweet, that dopamine hit is like heroin.
Right.
And I've never done heroin. But, like, it feels like the biggest thing. So, like, I am part of the problem, and I have been. But I also can see where we can all be a part of the solution if we work together. And I don't want to have to, like, you know, like, I don't think everybody wants to have the internet around forever. But it's kind of turning into this wild, wild west. And that's what WWW stands for. Just in case.
When you were just starting,
yes.
You said, let me get the quote right. You said, I want Katy Perry to be as much of a household name as Madonna. And it is now.
Is it?
Yeah, sure. I think it is.
Okay, thanks.
I mean, the fact that we even have to have the conversation means yes, it is. I mean, that there's even a question.
Thanks.
It is. So,
shout out Madonna.
The question is, why did you want that? Was it ultimately about this same thing, about craving love and feeling
sure.
like that would give you that love?
I think that's the seed of it all. I mean, I know that I have talent and I know that I work really, really hard. I mean, I think people can see some of that. And it's not always looking like this, in this way. And I apply myself every single day. But I think that, at the core of it, if you boil it down to its basic ingredient, is the desire to be loved. And I think we all feel that same desire to be seen, to be heard, and that's what this whole project is about, is to be a witness. And I think we're all a witness. Some of us are active witnesses, you know, some of us are putting our words into action or in activism, and then some of us are just kind of observing and being voyeurs and trying to figure out when's the right time to jump in.
And are you trying to move deliberately into being an active witness?
Yes, I am, and I think I already have, and I will. And just, even if it's not like being on the streets protesting or having, just holding space for people. Mm-hmm. I know that sounds like a really hippie thing, but just like, knowing people have to have their journeys and I have to have my journey, and I can't control what people do or think or how they respond to me. I can only control myself, and I should stop worrying about how to like control or manipulate them. Just like worry about me, do my thing. You know what I'm saying? But I think that, yeah, at the very, in the beginning was the desire to be loved. And I think everyone can relate to that. You know, no matter what situation you're in.
Would you wish that level of stardom on both somebody, just your level of stardom on somebody starting out, and would you wish it on your younger Katy Perry self?
Younger Katy Perry self was not ready. So I came to LA when I was 17, and I didn't get it happening until I was 23, and I went through a series of events where,
which incidentally, that's a very short amount of time.
Sure, but when you're only 32, that also feels like forever.
Right.
Okay, and especially when you're, you know, when you're 17, that's also forever. Do the
yeah.
math. I was promised no math, but do the math. And I think that, you know, we are sometimes, I believe in this kind of destiny where we're only given it when we're ready. Like, timing is everything, and relationships and success, sometimes it doesn't work out and you don't understand that. There's a lot of things that could be reasons to why. And I think maybe one of them is like, you're just not prepared for that.
And you're saying you were not prepared.
I was not prepared at 17. And I spent every day going, when, you know, and working hard, and it still wasn't like manifesting. And then at 23, it happened, and I had been signed and dropped by major record labels 3 different times. So people were like, no, we don't get it, we don't see it. But I did know that, like, the reason why I knew that there was something there is because I would go out and I would play, and people would respond. And that's kind of like YouTube, right? It's the modern day YouTube is kind of like the open mic. That's what the modern day YouTube is like, and the way you can respond is by, you know, pushing button or leaving a comment, and people will tell you if there's something there to start nurturing. But no, I mean, it's kind of a wild world. And you know, my problems are somewhat insignificant to real problems, of course. And again, like, I know my privilege. But you know, I think,
well, I mean, I think that's, I'm gonna let you off the hook as a superstar. I think that's easy to say that your problems are insignificant compared to other people's problems, but I think what I'm hearing you say, and what I also feel, is that any of our problems are insignificant compared to somebody else's suffering, but all of our problems are both unique to us
yes.
and relatable to each other.
Yes.
And we're all suffering the same issues.
Yeah. And I can see that in real time, especially when I go out on a limb and I talk about things that really make me uncomfortable, or I sing about them. You know, when I'm singing about, like, maybe having, you know, negative thoughts, or I'm singing about the pain that I endured in a relationship, or, you know, taking back my power, people really respond. And they're like, all of a sudden, all these things, all these people light up. They're like, me too, me too, me too, me too, me too, me too. You know, I was waiting for it. And that was music for me. It's just like Alanis Morissette, you know, that whole Jagged Little Pill record, every song made sense to me. Mm-hmm. And even like all these pop songs from Gwen Stefani to Ben Folds 5 was my favorite coming of age group, Ben Folds was. And like hearing Brick and driving on the 405 until, like, I, you know, my whole face was swollen like a tomato. It was just like, you know, sometimes I needed that. I need to release. I need to, like, I feel like crying is like the physical example of just letting it go and needing to release. Like, your pipes are almost too full and then they burst.
Right.
And so I think music is kind of therapeutic sometimes, and it's a great way to escape. It's all those things, and I love being a part of that.
I want to shift gears just a wee bit.
Wee bit.
Because I don't know how much time we're going to have, but I wanted to talk. It's something we touched on before, but I think it's worth talking about a little bit more. I was just reading in today's New York Times, maybe, the model Paulina Peretskova. I don't want to mispronounce her
name. I haven't been able to read the Times today. What is going on in the world?
I have had.
Are we still here?
I have nothing to do today. I had nothing to do except for prepare for this. So I was reading the Times, and she was writing an article about feminism, and she said in America, a woman's body. She was contrasting it to her homeland of Czechoslovakia and France, where she also spent some time in Sweden. She said in America, a woman's body seemed to belong to everybody but herself, and it struck me that must go 100-fold or 1,000-fold for a pop singer.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm wondering
there's a lot
how
of
you
show
relate to
me
that.
Your boobs.
Yes.
Comments. Well, you know, it's been a journey for me to realize my own sexual liberation.
What does that mean for you?
Okay, well, being comfortable in my body and not using it as a manipulative tool to get attention. Because, you know, that's what I wanted. I was craving love. You know what I'm saying? And now using it, not using it, but now being able to enjoy that beautiful thing that everybody is given is the consensual transaction of sex or intimacy, however which way you want to put it. And knowing that it's a God-given gift and it's primal and we all love it and partake in it, and it's a great stress reliever and all these wonderful things. There's lots of science behind it. And just kind of like taking it out of this like bad place, like this like dangerous place. And I think...
So wait, let me interrupt you for a second. When you say a bad place and a dangerous place, is that how you viewed your own sexuality as a bad or dangerous thing?
Maybe. Yeah, because I you know, I kind of grew up in a household where we didn't talk about it. I had no idea what it was. I mean, I was telling people earlier, like, I had no idea about my anatomy.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't get a real sexual education because people would rather sweep it under the mat and it doesn't exist. And people don't have the information. And so it was always super taboo for me. And then I started playing with like the taboo and realizing, not sure how taboo that is, but just questioning everything basically. And then now at 31, just realizing that like there's a liberation to this. And if I want to be, it's my choice now. And I don't have to use it as a manipulative tool. And that I can be both beautiful and intelligent. I don't have to separate it. Because that's a real strange one where, like, just because someone...
Did you feel that pressure?
Oh, my gosh. People thought I was dumb as SH. You know? They're like, how could she, like, have big old bitties and big old eyes and look cute and...
And a big old brain.
And a big old brain. And I've always had the big old brain. And, you know, to my own detriment, I kind of hid behind it. Like, I, like, created this Betty Boop character.
Right.
And that didn't do anything for me, necessarily. But I think you can be highly intelligent and highly good-looking. You can have both of those things.
I assume... I mean, is happening is you're talking about me right now.
Exactly.
And thank you.
You're welcome. I mean, I don't want to say, like, oh, so you think you're pretty. And I know I have features, and sometimes I look okay, and I have good days and bad days. But what I'm saying is that, like, you don't have to choose. And honestly, you know, with women, I feel like they don't have, I feel like people say they have to be one thing. And with me, especially, like, you know, people want me to be the last thing that I gave them, and they don't realize that time goes on, you know? They want to keep me in this capsule, like a little, like, fairy jar, and I understand that, because I created that fairy jar thingy. But I'm also human, and so I have to evolve as well. And sometimes, you know, with the internet, it's like pulling cement blocks. But I left my 20s. I'm in my 30s. It's been 4 years. You know, I've shed some skin. I've got to live through some things and live to tell. And so I think that I guess I just hope, you know, God bless you on your journey, and I hope you can do the same for me. That's what I say.
What I think is resonant about what you're saying is, although it's certainly true for you,
yeah,
that you have this very public life of evolution, it's also true, I think, for a lot of the people listening, that yeah, people around them place them in their own fairy jars,
yeah,
and that it's hard to unscrew that lid,
yes,
and fly free, fairy, fly free.
Yes. And like learn along the way, and like maybe that is a little bit why I'm so polarizing, is because, you know.
Do you think you're polarizing?
Sometimes I can't. I feel like I could be, because, you know, some I am vocal and I express my thoughts and opinions. And so what I thought maybe 4 years ago is not what I think now, because I've got the opportunity to learn more. Or even what I said 4 months ago maybe is something I, you know, wouldn't have said. But I'm still a little bit reactive, and that's my journey. I still deal with a little bit of ego. I mean, I just, like, imagine when you just have, like, this thing that you created, it's fun to fly on it,
yeah,
sometimes. So I deal with ego, and that's my journey, is to kind of, like, bring that down and, right, you know, ground
have,
it.
Have Katy Hudson say, shut up, Katy Perry.
Yeah, Katy Hudson needs to say, I created you. So calm your feathers.
Before I let you go, I end each episode with something called the Amazing Five, in which I will ask for a recommendation in each of five categories. And as you sprawl on the couch, I'm going to move the microphone a little bit so you
okay
can talk into it. I will
Thank
ask
you,
for
Michael.
A single recommendation.
A single.
In each of five categories.
I don't know anything, but I'll help.
Let's start with music. A recommendation in music.
A recommendation in music. Jack Garrett.
Jack Garrett?
Jack Garrett.
I don't know Jack
He's
Garrett.
He's amazing. You might like him. He's like, he is very soulful, but incredibly, he's an artisan of words. He's a wordsmith.
Uh-huh.
And he helped me write this song called Power on my record, and so I'm a huge fan. And I got to work with a lot of people, but I have a special little place in my heart
for Jack Garrett.
Yeah.
Fabulous. Food.
Food. Well, this morning James Corden woke me up with some delicacies, like a 1,000-year-old egg, and like
Wait,
cow's
you ate
tongue. No. I was not about to do
I
that.
I was going
to
say.
Scorpion. So I'm not going to recommend that.
But, plus, they're hard to find, those 1,000-year-old eggs.
Yeah, they're little. They're real delicacies. I can't believe it. Was it 1,000 or 100? I don't know. Brains becoming mashed potatoes. You know what? I'm going to go for local, anything done by Roy Choi, because he is a local guy and
LA chef
in the area, and I love local food, and especially him, who he, you know, he really accesses the community and gives them opportunity, and I believe in that so much. So,
books.
Well, okay. I mean, read Sapiens once. And
I don't know what Sapiens is.
Oh, okay. Sapiens.
I feel like I've heard of it.
Yeah, it's an amazing book that I'm still not yet finished with, but I'm in the middle of it. And it's just about the history of how Homo sapiens, became the dominant species.
Right.
Because there were like six of us.
Right, there was the Homo erectus and the Neanderthal.
Exactly.
And the other dudes.
All those dudes. And like, you know what it started to reveal for me is just that some of these feelings where, like, I'm like, this feels like, do I really have to do this? You know, my primal self is going, no, you created this idea, you know? Mm. We're actually supposed to be with a bunch of people surrounding, like, raising the babies and stuff like that, you know? It's that great feeling of, like, having a community, because I love having my family nearby, and I want to, like, I definitely want that communal feeling?
Movie or TV?
Well, I'm a documentary person, so I either have to have sci-fi. If I'm gonna go for escapism,
what's your sci-fi right now?
Oh well, it's always just been Fifth Element or Blade Runner.
Right on. You're excited for the new one?
Yes, of course. Rachel from Blade Runner is my favorite in the world. She's so beautiful. I'm wondering who's playing her.
Right.
Okay, or she's even in there.
I don't know
these questions. But I would say all my favorite documentaries would have to be After the Flood or 13th.
Is After the Flood, is that New Orleans?
No, it's about climate change. It's Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh, got it.
It's amazing. And it boils it down so brilliantly. And everyone that's watching, like, After the Flood, wow, you don't understand climate change? I get it, because it's slow. Mm-hmm. You know, the climate change that's happening is slow. But it's starting to compound and speed up. And there's an amazing documentary about that. And 13th, about mass incarceration.
That's Ava DuVernay. And then I know that one's on Netflix, and that's one of those ones, and I'm like, I have to watch this, and I don't want to be bummed out, so I'm not going to watch it right now. But I'm going to watch it tonight because of you.
Oh, great, awesome.
And then finally, miscellaneous, anything from your life that you would recommend to others? It could be any idea. I'm looking for the first thing that pops into your mind,
okay, well,
however silly.
It's not silly at all. I mean, I think it can be great. I love meditating. It's my favorite thing that I've, my favorite tool that I've ever learned.
And you specifically do transcendental meditation,
transcendental
right?
Transcendental meditation,
and
yes.
Now, my reading of transcendental meditation is that it requires a teacher, that it's not something you can teach yourself. Is that correct?
Correct. And there is just mindful meditation, and I've had a couple of teachers here that would, you can look tarabrock.com, I believe. She's an incredible mindful meditation, which is a guided meditation, which is good for anxiety. And then TM, though, is kind of a tool that, you know, it takes some applying, I guess you would say. But you just go to, just look it up on Google.
Yeah, and then it'll direct you to
the teachers in your area. And there's also, you know, scholarship programs and all. It's like you can pay a small fee to do it, to learn, or you can apply for whatever your situation is, if you don't have the money. And it's changed my mind. It's like, it gives me so much capacity. So I'll just give you an example. For instance, I was so tired today and I just took a 10-15 minute meditation. And when you meditate, you access the deepest rest you'll ever access, because you're either awake or you're sleeping, and a lot of times when you're sleeping, your subconscious is just going in overtime. It's like that factory starts. It's like the night shift goes on, and you're like, why did I eat this food, run into this wall, jump, and then fly, and have sex with this random person? You know what I'm saying? It all in your dreams, and you wake up, and you've slept for 8 hours, and you're like, I'm exhausted. Because you lived a whole other life in your subconscious. And, of course, sleep is really, really important, but I think that sometimes we are always worried about the future, and we're upset about the past, and we're never living in the present. And meditation really brings you present, and it accesses that deep well of rest. And in that well is a lot of creativity, and that's where I get most of my ideas.
Well, Katy Perry, I want to thank you for taking the time. Congratulations
you
on your new album. Congratulations
so
on your journey, a journey that I find myself on.
Yes, sir.
The same journey. I think we're all on the same journey
yes,
together.
Yes, and I'm so proud. I'm proud of us.
We're doing great work, you and
thank
I.
Thank you so much for coming to Witness Worldwide headquarters.
Well, thank you for being here, and thank you for being amazing.
You're amazing. No, you're real. No, you're really amazing.
I'm going to apply it to everybody. I'm going to say the you is applicable to everybody.
Great.
And we're all amazing.
Thanks.
Cool. Thank you, Katy.
Thank you.
May I
implore
you for an autograph for my daughter?
Oh, yes, of course. I'd love to.
She begged me.
Do you want me to do it? Should we do it on your Witness Worldwide?
Yeah, I was thinking that.
Because it's like something that no one has.
I was thinking maybe this, which is the questions and the notes, and maybe that would be more interesting. And then I'll give her this, too.
Awesome.
I mean, maybe she'd like this better. This would be better.
How young is she?
She's 14.
Oh, yeah. This is amazing. Tell me.
Ruthie. For some reason, I expected you to know it. I'm like, just
well,
make
I did. It's actually Elijah and Ruthie.
Yeah.
What does she like to do?
She likes lacrosse. She likes field hockey. I shouldn't say she likes lacrosse. She hates lacrosse, but she plays lacrosse. She loves field hockey.
Field hockey?
Yeah.
So she's strong.
She is strong. How's the rest of your night? Is it busy?
It's going to be a noise. It's going to be so fun. I get to hang out with Van Jones.
I like Van Jones. He's a really interesting guy.
Yeah, and we're going to have a cast of characters here tonight. You know, from all different backgrounds with all different beliefs, and that's it. Here, you
Fantastic.
Want me to do this for Elijah?
Oh, that would be sweet of you. Thank you.
How old is Elijah?
16.
Okay. He doesn't care. He's like, please.
No, I think he cares, but he's too cool to say he cares.
Oh, we all know that. Yeah. Well, huh? Stay cool.
Stay cool. That really says it all, doesn't it?
Yeah. Whatever that means. Awesome.
Thank you, Katy.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it.
Witnessing Michael Ian Black, everyone. Hi, amazing. Everyone. You're like, I'm going to start talking to the walls. When I get out of this thing.
I hope that was all right for you.
Yes, it was amazing. I appreciate it. Awesome.
Thanks.
Thanks so much. Oof. Thank you. Wait. Did you guys come together?
No.
You work here.
Yeah, I'm just the audio guy.
You are. Nice to see you.
Nice
Hello,
to meet you.
Katy. Hi.
Oh.
Okay, hi, Allison.
Hi.
Do you want a drink for the road?
Oh, no, thank you. It's very nice of you.
No.
All right, I'll walk you to the front door.
Thanks, Katy.
Yeah. Have you been to the blogger room?
No.
The blogger room.
No.
Have someone lead you to the blogger room. This is a two-way mirror, and people are in there.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
Can someone lead Michael to the blogger room to show him after they...
Thanks again.
Bye. Thanks
really appreciate
lot.
It. Take care.
Have a good one. Muffin! Oh, nugget?
Okay. Okay.
Ooh.
Said the glue's not really working on that, so he put that on there as well.
Right. That's great. Please tell Tony this is good.
Mm-hmm.
But make sure that like the fabric in between the patches doesn't shrink, therefore making the outfits like a little smaller when they sew them together.
Okay.
So give them ample enough room, please.
Yeah. Copy that.
Can I see my iPad, please?
Yes.
May I?
May I get your approval on...
This. Where are we?
Which one of these you want to approve?
I didn't do the other one yesterday, but that's okay, right?
This is not for her, but it's for CoverGirl.
Yeah.
Luke.
This goes that into one. A full delete.
This one actually is pretty good for the internet. Just like applause. That's a Deloitte.
Save as draft. Delete.
Oh. Delete these, Aya.
Why?
Yes. Delete that, Aya.
Full possessed.
That's good. Yes.
Vogue. Yes. Pterodactyl hands.
You know. That one, please.
Copy. Thank you.
Okay.
And
we're 2 hours late.
Your next guest is ready.
What?
We're gonna do it in here, though, so we are just waiting for sound stuff to be cleared out.
One more question while we're waiting.
I know, we're all in here.
Psst.
There's go. Two questions in there. One question, two questions.
Huh? What?
Two questions.
I don't know. So, no, I don't need to, probably. Okay.
Cool. Trailer's not there.
No.
Okay.
No.
And then, is this, okay, do you want to look at it?
No, keep, just do it.
It's okay.
It's amazing. And I think...
It's amazing.
It also, I think, like, up to
it's
their...
It's already been...
It don't ask me, because it's, the people are seeing it.
Okay.
It's up to, I mean, this is a free-for-all.
Yep. It is what it is. Que sera, sera.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Well. I can't. See who my friends are. I'll be able to.
Who your friends are?
That are coming to Dean.
Oh, I was like in life. I mean.
Wait till you see this beautiful picture that I took of me.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. By the way.
We're no longer friends.
By the way, that's my career.
Sabotage.
There, yeah. Yes.
Okay. I'm just gonna go potty.
Okay. Yeah. Why? Do I need to step in there and help them? What's taking him so long? I'm gonna go stare and make them uncomfortable. Look, I'm magic. Magic. Until it falls. Yes, sir.
So I am excited and I am ready.
Great. They are just wrapping cables and then we can. I have one more question for
you. I have one question for you. Is that person that said that they were going to fly in here for tonight?
This is...
No.
This is.
No.
That's it. That's.
Oh, no.
That's everyone.
Starts with an H.
Who?
Starts with an H.
No.
Got it.
So,
one last question.
This
is what?
Is the stage.
There's nothing there.
It's brilliant.
Oh, there's nothing there.
This? I cannot show you. Why?
But I think when Derek and I are in our chat,
it's not happening now.
Why?
Because he doesn't have anything to interview you for.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
great.
He's just coming.
Awesome.
To be a part of the conversation.
I'm so excited to see
yes.
him. Hi, Derek. Talking about you, honey. Love you.
I really have to pick my nose. I'm doing it.
Do it.
I'm doing it. I gotta pick it. It was bugging me.
Everyone does it.
Everyone does it.
Despite the fact that some people deny it.
Deny it, please.
It
Get
is.
Real.
We are all...
Get real.
Homo sapiens.
Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens. I am so excited. I haven't been able to put on the music as much as I wanted to put on today. But I guess we're going to play some music right now.
Sure.
Did we use the liquid?
You know what's a really good trick for saying I love you? Just if you mouth olive juice.
No, it's fine.
It's I love you. All. It looks like I love you.
Send them in. Send her in. Chris?
Mmm.
Ah, okay.
Mmm.
Oh, yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yep. Oh. Mmm.
Where's my thing? Mm. Nugget! Well, who could it be? One of my favorite people and a friend.
Queen.
Hello, welcome! Hello. Come on in, Queen!
Hello.
Hello, my queen.
Creature.
Hello, hey. David. It's so nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you, too.
I'm so happy to have you. Welcome. Let me
Thanks.
Close. Let me close the door. Welcome.
Oh my God. This
Hello,
is amazing.
Cameras.
Hi,
Hello,
everyone.
Hello, all the cameras.
Hey,
Nugget.
World.
Sit. Sit.
Oh.
Oh, that is a sweet girl.
Good sit. You're such a good sit.
Oh.
Okay, but hold on. Good
it's
sit.
It's Butter a beanie stay. Baby. A live beanie baby.
A live beanie baby here.
Yes.
Incredible.
Oh my gosh. Oh my
Hello.
Gosh.
I
How
miss
are you?
You?
I know. Hey, I brought you something.
Okay.
I was shopping today and really randomly just saw these and I had to bring them.
It's yes! The it's the eyes. Eyes. Yes, queen.
Yes.
Amazing. It's like a subtle eye.
It
Thank
is.
You so
yes.
much.
Thanks for having us.
Everybody, if you haven't realized who's at the door, this is the one and the only, needs no introduction, the amazing Kacey Musgraves.
Hi.
You know I love Kacey, and I'll tell you about how we've met and all that stuff. And also, this is our friend David Fransisco. Am I saying
Here
that
I
correct?
Fransisco.
Fransisco.
You like an elf.
By the way, you have the most beautiful eyes.
Oh. No, you have
that
the most
match.
Beautiful eyes.
Well, thanks. Oh. Thank you. You're a beautiful human. I can't Aww. Wait to share your story. I think we have a video to share, which is amazing.
Oh, wow.
We have the video awesome. To share, correct?
Yeah.
Maybe. They'll tell you in your ear.
Yep.
I'm very excited. We're going to go to the confessional.
This
cool.
is insane. I love it.
Thank you. And this oh. is the world.
Yeah, it's awesome. I've been watching.
Have you been watching?
Yeah, it's really
no,
cool.
No, I'm okay. kind of really, yeah, really cool. I'm kind of addicted now. Like,
it's funny yeah. to not, like, no one's responding to us. We're just talking. But people are watching, you know?
Yeah.
And I guess they're responding
yeah.
on
I just feel like
online.
I'm in my pocket
they are
all day.
Yes, I am in your pocket all day. Yeah. Would you guys like some water, some sparkling water?
Yes.
Or some regular water?
Some
you want
sparkling water?
There's I love a
sparkling.
Is there a strawberry sparkle?
Oh, look at that meat.
Hey, Kate.
What's up?
Thanks for having me.
Okay, this
thanks for coming. Sorry for bringing you first to meet.
Yeah.
It's all good.
Is this its
May
full
I have one as
time?
Well, please?
Yeah.
I believe so. Do we have extra strawberry sparkling?
Wow. Okay, so what kind
such
of.
A
oh, okay. I'm Tamara.
I'm David.
I have my coffee.
Okay. What did you say your name was?
Tamara.
Tamara.
Tam.
So precious.
Okay, how does it stay this small?
You know they zoomed in on her while you were doing your meditation. They zoomed in on this dog and it was like the best. She was sitting right there.
Oh, really?
It was incredible.
Really?
Yeah. She was like she was posing for the camera.
You guys are so funny.
I really like the bandana though.
It was incredible.
I know, it's chic. I can carry yours in.
Okay.
It's a tracksuit. I was noticing this from afar. I was like, dang.
It's great.
Let's go into the confessional.
Here, I'll run these
here, Tams, will you?
The confessional. Where secrets are revealed.
You're free to just say anything you want.
Wow.
Anything? I was told I can't cuss on here.
I know, but they do have a bleeper.
Oh,
so.
They do?
Don't
ooh,
be shy.
This is creepy though, the eye and the mouth.
Be in there.
Nice.
This
room.
You only
this room.
I like
room.
It.
I'm gonna be.
I've already gone through.
I think we're all gonna be playing together. Are we all playing together?
Whatever you want to do.
Let's all play together.
Let's all play together.
That's amazing. But before we play, I want to talk. And do we have a video?
I don't know what video you want, but I will get it up for you.
It's the video that introduced David and his story.
Got it. I will find it, and we will find it.
Music
can we do it at the very end? No?
It might explain me better at the beginning.
I love the beginning of explanation here. Let's give this.
Okay.
Thank you.
I think. Anyways, we could do our best to talk about it. Okay. So, okay. Kacey Musgraves, first and foremost.
The nugget.
Hi, Muffin. Kacey Musgraves, you joined me on tour, and also we've written songs together. We have to finish that one.
I know. I feel like it was so slow that day, but it's really good though. Actually.
She's an incredible songwriter and an incredible artist. Please check her out. Her songs and lyrics really mean a lot to me, and I know they mean a lot to a bunch of other people. And What's Merry-Go-Round was kind of your first breakout song that we all heard on the internet. And it was almost like maybe my inspiration for Chain to the Rhythm goes the same with Merry-Go-Round.
Awesome. Yeah.
Nice. And I think that, like, you know, you're a really brilliant observer. Like, you're a brilliant witness of the world. And you just kind of, how do you write a song? Tell us how. Because she writes incredible songs.
Thank you very much. Coming from you, that means a lot to me.
Seriously. You're like the best.
No, but really, like, you're the best. Your mom's the best.
My mom is the best.
So, I don't know. It starts with an idea, just a little nugget.
A little
nugget.
Oh.
And I put it in my phone, and, like, I could be having an argument with somebody, and I'm like, ding, okay, that's an idea for a song. Or
I stop everything
you
and I
have
go, wait.
To. Or it's gone forever.
Yeah.
Or like, does it ever come to you in dreams? Like, and you have to wake up and you have to write it down. I don't know.
I get it in meditative situations, like in the shower. Do you get things in the shower?
Yeah, just like, it'll just hit you from nowhere.
Uh-huh.
But I have to write it down and I'll just save up a whole bank of all these like little nuggets of ideas. And then, I'll just revisit them later and then they sometimes turn into something, you know? And it's been fun. I've been writing a lot lately.
Our process
it's been awesome.
The same.
Yeah.
It's very similar.
And, like, I'm usually words more than, more lyric-based than, like, melodies and stuff.
Yes.
You know? I don't know how you are, but.
Well, I do all of it, but it's melodies and lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
But it's amazing to hear that. And you're in the middle of making your third record?
Yeah. I mean, I'm just starting. Like,
just
starting. I just, you know.
Don't give, no you, expectation,
you,
no pressure.
Well, yeah. But you know how it is. You just want to basket songs that you think
it would
are all
be KM3.
Awesome. KM3, unless the Christmas album counts, but does it count though?
I loved that, by the way. You were the epitome of Christmas.
Christmas!
You, like, those costumes.
Thanks.
And, like, the songs and the way you recorded them.
Thanks.
You really did Christmas justice.
Thanks.
And I had a great Christmas because of that record.
Thanks.
And you took, and the music video.
Oh,
a whole bit
dude.
Set.
Thanks.
You really like
that.
Put in the most effort.
I really cared.
You really cared
about
music,
business.
And the music videos that you do, like especially that one with the puppets. What was that one called?
Oh, Biscuits.
Biscuits.
Mind your own biscuits.
You're refreshing. You know, I love all music and I love country music. And, you know, country music is so many different things.
Right.
Just like pop music is so many different things. And you are an interesting version of country music. And I would liken it to a little bit like Dolly Parton.
Oh, thanks.
She's really been an amazing storyteller.
Yeah.
And she's one of my absolute heroes.
Yes.
Heroes upon heroes. Mm-hmm. And I love her. I've seen her in concert. And she really knows how to tell a story. And she's a wordsmith. And you are as well.
Thanks.
You know, she wrote some of those greatest songs. And you're writing these great songs.
And she loves sparkly outfits. And all of that. But she can tell a story. And just, like, that's how I feel about you. You can just sit with your guitar and do the same thing. And it translates, you know, the same or whatever. So
it all comes down to, like, breaking down
the song.
Yeah. It really does.
If you don't have a song, I feel like you really don't have anything. You know what I mean?
Especially as a musician.
Preach.
And you would know David. So, yes. David, you're a producer and a musician as well.
As well as a songwriter,
And a songwriter. Yeah. And I want to talk about David. David is here representing an incredible organization that I believe in, that I love, that maybe you haven't heard of, but we want to, like... shed some light. Take that spotlight and just go like that. And it's called Music Cares, musiccares.org. And can you tell us about Music Cares?
Right. Well, I will be a witness for Music Cares. Basically, it's an organization funded by the Grammys that provides for musicians in need. Anyone that has, for instance, like my story, which you'll see soon, an accident or something happened. They stepped up to the plate for me and so many other people in our industry. And it's really cool to have our own group of people that do that. It's kind of like our own insurance in a way, but like I don't even pay a monthly, no one pays a monthly thing for
really?
It. It's just like I was put in touch with them and they've actually paid my housing in Nashville over the past 6 months.
That's awesome.
Really?
Yeah.
I have a friend that, you know, needed some rehabilitation and had some substance situation, and Music Cares actually was the organization that came in and helped sponsor that rehabilitation. Because sometimes, you know, when you think about going to rehab or what have you, you think it's just like, oh, I'll decide to go to rehab. Rehab can be really, really expensive.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And so it's amazing because, and I want you to share more about your situation, but for me, I just want to say that, like, there's this thing I think that a lot of musicians or creative people struggle with, and it's a bit of mental health.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't talk about it as much, and I think it's pretty rampant, and we're seeing some of that, you know, like, there's been situations where people have lost their lives over their mental health fight, and you think, oh, this person was amazing, like, on the surface, they had everything, and
why would they do that?
Why would they fall, like, so hard like that?
Well, it's also, like, the culture of, like, Instagram these days. Everybody just chooses the little slivers of, like, what they want people to see.
Sure.
So, it's, like, really accurate.
And sometimes we grow a whole life of that.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
sometimes artists grow a whole life of that, and we forget that there's a safe place like Music Cares to talk, to come together and say, look, you know, it's not been so great. Or like, you know, it's this weird thing where like you can get so high. There's so many high highs, so many low lows.
Yeah.
You know, and you can get addicted to it. And sometimes it's there and sometimes not. Sometimes it's great. Sometimes it turns on you.
Yeah.
And so there's all these things. But creative people, I think, you know, in general, sometimes they feel overwhelmed by their thoughts or the way of thinking. And, you know, someone like you who it's not just a mental health, it's an actual physical health thing that you went through. And I want to hear more about your story.
Yeah. Well, do they have the video? It might not be a good place to start. But
I know. I would like, let me check.
I can just go for
it. Well, let me just check really quickly. Excuse me 1 second.
Meanwhile, I'll play with the perfect dog.
I know, right? Hey, how are you, Aya?
Come and play.
Oh, you don't have it yet?
Sweet.
Hello,
everyone.
I have a question for David. Is all the music in it his?
David, is all the music in it you?
I think so. Yeah. It depends on which one.
I think so.
From Vimeo?
The one from Vimeo.
If it's 20 minutes, that's...
No, it's 3 minutes.
3 minutes? I can't remember which one that is. 3 minutes.
It's the one that tells your...
Is it like the pedaling bike?
No, it's the one where you share your story and then...
Is it called Keep the Faith, maybe?
I think so, yeah.
That one is all me.
That's all him.
Okay, if it's all him, guys.
Oh.
This thing.
What a sweet
boy. I know.
Rusty, we're getting one, wherever you are. I know you're watching.
Rusty! Oh, by the way, congratulations.
Thanks, dude. I found a wedding dress yesterday.
You did? Where?
Yes.
this
you
story.
You failed to mention this.
No, I it's know. Like, yeah, what I'm it, so excited.
Is it, like, what is it? Tell us how you found it. Come on. This is good stuff.
Well, it's
I mean, you're also sharing it with the
I know.
Whole world.
It's this company, though, that I really love called Berta Bridal.
Yeah.
And, like, I don't know. It's just magic.
Is it?
It's awesome.
And you put it on and you felt.
Yeah, I was like, I fucking love this.
It's all right. No, it's great. Congratulations.
Hey.
Look at that, Rusty.
That is so awesome.
Rusty.
That, he did a really good job.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't help at all.
You didn't help.
No. I gave help. I gave strong direction. I mean, I'm the one who has to wear it, so.
I still got the Pinterest board going and everything.
Yeah. That secret Pinterest that you accidentally.
I know, right?
Oh, by the way, that you accidentally left open one evening.
Oops.
You know, that.
Like, has all your wedding plans, like your future kids' names, yeah. Everything.
Exactly. Well, before we go into it, I just want to like direct people to the Music Cares website, musiccares.org. It was established in 1989 by the Recording Academy, Music Cares, and it's a nonprofit health and human service organization that helps members of the music industry in times of financial, medical, and personal hardship. So basically, like, you know, you don't have to be like Kacey Musgraves or Katy Perry to be able to enjoy and right. lean on this program. You can be right. anyone, any yeah. musician. And Music Cares MAP Fund, it allows access to addiction recovery and sober living resources. It has safe harbor rooms, weekly addiction support groups, and a sober touring network that's amazing. And over the past, so a little fact, over the past 10 years, Music Cares has provided close to $10 million in assistance to nearly 3,000 substance abuse clients. So it's been amazing.
Did you ever go to the dinner they do, the gala?
Oh, yeah. Person of the Year? I've been to it, and it was amazing. I got to sing a song for Paul McCartney's night.
I was there the Carol King year. That was so fun. It was me and Miguel, and we like did Crying in the Rain. And it was
you did cool. amazing.
Oh my gosh.
So
that's
let me just incredible. Double check yeah. if we don't have our
I can
video.
Go for, I honestly I can tell, go for it, but
guys,
whatever's easy.
Hello.
Yep.
What's up?
Yep.
Yes or no?
Yeah, it's happening.
Can we start it now, please?
Yep.
This is what we call behind the scenes, like hello production.
That's what I love about this.
I know it's shows awesome. The real. So let's show this clip right now. That tells David's story, and it's an amazing clip. It's why I wanted to invite you here today.
Oh.
We're just gonna stare at the wall.
It's a cool picture.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
It's a sweet puppy. We could pet the puppy.
This is like my dry run for having a TV show maybe in life. I don't know.
You should just keep living in here.
Should I just keep living in here?
Do you forget that there's cameras?
I'm starting to forget, yeah. Like which like I almost
farting.
Took my, I almost, well.
Have you yet?
Yeah, but like I've done those ones that like don't make any noise.
Just real quiet.
Yeah.
It's a gamble. Scary. You don't know.
It's a gamble.
The problem is like when I come out, when I go out for the third time, you know, Mama ain't happy. Mama is not having it. We're trying to share some stories. We're trying to uplift and empower. You can hear me on the microphone. Mama is not having it. She has had it for the third time. Aya.
We're trying.
Oh, really?
Sip on my beverage.
Okay.
Buy your beverage, girl. That's a good beverage.
Anyway, I like these shoes, though.
Yes, they say Katy Perry.
No,
it's not.
We're good. We can talk about it.
Okay. Well, you just.
Let's just talk how about it.
Oh, here we go. Can you start from the beginning?
Yes. So Black
sorry,
Bird
we're
was
gonna.
The place to do
can
that.
We stop from the
awesome
beginning, please?
Here we go. Here we go. Technology, you know, sometimes it fails us.
This is from Music Cares. That's right.
Yes, it's from Music Cares.
This is the video. Okay, yeah, this is all me.
Yes. Sorry, everybody. Watch out.
Damn. That's my back.
Well, I was recording in Knoxville professionally at the time, but it's a small pond and I wanted to expand and learn from the best. So Blackbird was the place to do that, and they have an awesome educational program, so I decided to go there. Yeah, so I was just going home from class, and it was about 3 weeks in, and I was on my bicycle, and we stopped at a red light, and it turned green for us, and we started going, and I was in the front with this other car. And a car just ran a red light, totally didn't see it. And the car beside me stopped in time, but I couldn't see past the car, so I just kept going and got T-boned about 35 miles an hour. Went about 100 feet. My arm was laid open and bleeding profusely. They thought that I had broken my arm really bad, but actually I broke my spine and couldn't move a thing from my waist below. Then I went down to Atlanta to the Shepherd Center for some rehab for 8 solid months. So I am back in Blackbird. I just started 3 weeks ago. I'm gonna be there for 6 months, learning about how to engineer and record. Honestly, I don't know if I could have done it without the support that I've received from first family, second friends, and then the music community. People that I have never met in my life stepping up and supporting me. And thanks to Music Cares, I don't have to worry about the rent here. The theme has been redemption, taking a broken thing and it being redeemed. Hey everyone, thank you so much for being here tonight, and I just want to tell you that it's people like you who've made it possible for people like me who have an in.
That's basically it.
That's basically it. And Music Cares stepped in. And like, how do they step in? Can you give me a little information on that?
Well, so I was at Blackbird, which is John McBride, Martina McBride's husband.
Shout out.
She owns it. Shout out.
Nashville.
Yes. By the way, I love Nashville. You know. I just want to call out Nashville. I love you so much because they taught me how to write a song.
Yeah.
Like, I went to Blackbird Cafe. Do they have it?
Bluebird.
Not Blackbird.
Lots of birds in Nashville.
There's lots of birds. And I sang in the round. That was like one of my first times performing when I was like 13. And they really taught me how to write a song. Because there's amazing songwriters.
They're the best.
The talent is incredible.
Yeah.
Really incredible. So Martina and John connected me to Dave and Herb. Do you know Dave Pensado, Herb? They have a show. It's for like producers.
Right.
So I got connected to them and they hooked me up with Music Cares. So it's a small, I love it. I mean, I've been immersed, and this is an example of it, me being here today, immersed in the music community. And it's actually been really incredibly encouraging.
It's amazing. I love, that's the thing, is like it's this kind of, the keyword has been intersectionality. So it's all these communities coming together and like all of us realizing, sure, we have our own little things and some of us have our own struggles and sets of problems or things that we like or taste, but like we're all these little communities coming together as one. And it's amazing Music Cares, and I think it's an amazing organization that if any other musicians are watching right now, that they want a place, you know, to feel safe to talk, or they're struggling from substance abuse, that is a great place to go. But
yeah, it's crazy. They Nashville had a flood, like, I think it was maybe 5 years back, and it was like, for some reason, this devastating flood that came out of nowhere. And so many beautiful instruments got ruined, like in this flood or whatever, and they replaced a lot of people's instruments, gear, whatever. Like, I didn't know that they even like went as far and did like the substance stuff or like that. I just heard about the gear thing. That's crazy.
They do a lot. I think you can check them out on musiccares.org. And Kacey, I invited you here because, you know, I got to see your love letter that you wrote to the LGBTQ community, and it was concerning your song Follow Your Arrow.
Yes.
Right? And today's Gay Pride here in LA.
I got my rainbow on.
Work that rainbow.
It's so cute. LA's so happy right now. Like, I just love how LA is so happy and rainbow, and like, and everyone's in a good mood because of Pride Week, and like,
everyone is proud to be themselves, and I think we all want to live our most authentic lives. Like, that's the goal, to live
your
authentic life and live your life that you would like. And so I was really moved by that and really moved by you in general. And I want to play some music with, I want you to, if you have a guitar out there.
Yeah, get it out.
Get
your capo out, get a pick.
Get your capo.
Or you can actually just play, you don't need
air
a capo.
Guitar.
You don't need a capo.
You can do air guitar.
Yep.
Or you can just watch this video later because we are live streaming it, but then we're going to post it. I'm sorry, Muffin.
God.
I'm sorry, Muffin.
I just want to eat it.
Even cuter in person, everyone.
And I would like to have a guitar lesson, if that's okay, right before we start dinner.
Okay.
Because
I don't.
That's yours. That's
this
yours.
Is mine.
So yeah, wait. Oops. Fun fact about Arrow. So Katy brought me to write.
Oh, tell us.
Wait, this was, you were writing for Prism. So when was that? Like 4 years ago.
No. It's almost 5 years ago.
Damn. Okay. Sorry, I cussed again.
No. Damn is okay, actually.
Is that okay?
Damn.
Okay, so yeah, she brought me to LA.
Because I just think you're a fantastic songwriter, and I love collaborating. It's my favorite
thing.
So
fun, and yeah, I was so pumped, so excited, and yeah, so I had a little basket of ideas, as you do, and I brought them, and Follow Your Arrow was one. It was just like a little seed of an idea, and I just kind of wanted it to be about, like, encouraging a soul of some kind to just, yeah, live the kind of life that they want to live, because, you know, someone's gonna have a problem with something anyway, so you might.
Oh,
well
everybody
just,
has an opinion. You know, opinions are like assholes.
Or that. Exactly.
we all got one.
Big ol', yeah.
Whoa.
Whatever. anyway, I brought the song to the session. I was like, hey, what about this? I have this little tiny idea. It's called Follow Your Arrow, and I played it. And Katy, you really liked it, but you were like, you know what? I really think that this is an idea that you should keep for yourself. And I was like, okay. So I ended up finishing it later in Nashville. And
I thought it was brilliant. It wasn't me saying, keep it, you know, that internet lingo.
Yeah.
It wasn't that at all. It was really me just saying, look, no, this is special.
Like, you should say this.
This is special, and this is for you. And, like, it was a brilliant little nugget.
Thanks. So anyway, it ended up being a really fun song. And I feel like it ended up bringing a lot of people to country music that wouldn't normally have been there, and anyway, it made me really happy.
Because let's before we go into it.
So what was this? I'm not that great at guitar.
Okay. Oh please! You're magnificent.
I basically shred.
What is that? Fifth fret.
Basically shred.
Fifth fret. That would okay. So we're
one,
gonna be playing
two, three, four,
like
five.
I'm playing in the C position because mm-hmm. I'm really basic.
No. Hey, stop. Listen, here's the thing, okay? Honestly, stop with this judgment. You are one of my favorite female guitar players.
Dang, okay.
The fact that you can sing and play at the same time and sound beautiful while doing it, and thanks. Like, I can play guitar a little bit, and I grew up playing guitar, and I kind of deserted playing guitar.
No, I've seen you
while.
In those open tunings. It sounds really good.
It's really fun. I go back to my roots every once in a while, but it is also fun writing to like a trap song. You know, it's fun.
So fun. Yeah.
It's fun writing to a beat like something in the studio, but it's also beautiful to be able to pick up an instrument. And I just want to say that you're amazing.
Thanks.
So this C is, I think, more of the exalted C. Just rather, I think this is more of like the basic C.
Yeah. Well,
this is like,
I don't
nice.
Know.
Yeah,
I like to use the kinky because you have a root note in there. You can have like the bass note or whatever.
So this is the C.
So like if you didn't have one of these things, the capo, you would be playing an F chord up here. You know.
I can be the guy who does those chords.
Yeah.
David.
I'll be that guy.
We are double teaming this thing. Yeah. So awesome.
Why?
Okay.
Can you tell me what the, why would we use a capo as opposed to not? I mean, if you have one,
okay.
Great.
It's basically a way to, not cheat, but it's like, okay, if you were not using a capo, you would be in a different position. You'd be playing in a different position. So that would require different chords.
Yeah.
And
I think sometimes it
basically moves the neck up to here. So you can be playing. I don't know how to explain it.
Well, I think it's like prettier
Google
sometimes.
It.
It's more open sounding.
It's more
for
open.
Sure.
It's more
well,
angelic
it,
sounding.
It makes the it shortens the neck so you're playing at a higher register.
And by the way, your
so
capo is
it's
bedazzled.
It's a little crazy. I mean, it needs to calm down. It's a little bit.
I've never heard of a capo calming down, but I like it. So
you
see.
Have a, yeah. Okay. So yeah. But you're playing in the F position.
I'm gonna play no capo for those at home who want
to
know the chords without capo. Okay.
And you can watch this.
Okay.
I've got a couple extra notes.
So, okay.
I've got a couple extra notes.
So.
Oh, actually, can I borrow one of those?
Yes, you can.
I never have picks, ever. Nope. Okay. So, we're gonna just. It has. This drum pattern has. Yep, C. You're gonna start on the C position. It has a little hop to it. So, cool. You're gonna go. And then the second chord is going to be an A. It's an A minor position.
Oh, I love an A minor.
Oh, love it.
Which is a C minor for those at home.
Yes. I like that you're bringing the scientific, like, okay. So, or there's a thing in Nashville called the Nashville number system, but I mean, it's used all over the world. I need to learn it. I want to learn it.
It's
because
it's
you know
simple,
it.
Yeah.
Is it music theory?
It's music and numbers. So if we're in the key of F, F is one.
Your
and
root
then,
chord is your one. Is right. a one. So it's like 1, 4, 5.
It's a beautiful thing because you
it
can
makes
tell
it
me,
universal.
Yeah, you, she could tell me the numbers of the song.
1, 4, 5.
It's a 1, 4, 5. And this then, one is then, a 1 minor 6. 1 minor 6.
Then you would automatically know the changes, and it wouldn't matter what key you're in, right?
Right.
So
right.
yeah,
exactly.
You need numbers.
Yeah. They don't, I don't know much about that.
They don't lie.
Yeah. Okay, so C position, A minor position. There's only like 4 chords in the song, so
that's
once you
okay.
have those.
Do you know like most of the Beatles songs are like
yeah,
a
so
few
easy.
Chords?
Right. 3 chords and the truth. It's country music. So
okay, 3 chords and the truth is country music.
Welcome to Nashville.
Yeah. Yes!
So you only need a handful of chords. So, anyways, C position, the A minor position.
Yes.
You're gonna do an F.
Ooh, what's what
B flat?
What?
Yep.
You do a fantasia.
I do.
She's just doing the high strings. It's nice.
And then we're gonna have a D minor in there too. D minor.
My F a G minor.
Oh, and then there is this, the G position.
Yep.
The G.
So there's 5 chords.
Yep. Stay at home.
So should we
go
try
through
them?
Okay, so let's call out the chords as we're going through them.
Okay. So this is where the number system would
you
really
just say the
play.
Chords.
Okay,
well,
I'll say.
We're gonna say it to the restaurant.
C. A minor position. I hate saying that because it's not a C that I'm playing.
You can just,
you know
from now
mean?
On.
Okay.
We're calling them by those
look
things.
Look at my hands. Look at my little hands. Okay. C. A minor. C again. A minor. So C. You save yourself from marriage or for A minor. You don't.
We got to the chorus.
So we got excited about the chorus.
You did.
You nailed it up to that point.
Yeah.
That was great.
You were.
Make
you
lots of noise as a C.
Mm-hmm. A minor. Kiss lots of boys.
Kiss lots of boys.
And back.
C.
Mm-hmm.
Kiss lots of girls.
And then if that's something.
And then D minor.
Uh-huh.
If that's something.
And then on to the G.
You're in.
You're in two. And it's kind of the same thing again. Straight. It's a little two. Back to the A minor. Roll up on joint.
Roll up a joint while you are in California.
It's legal, Nana.
Nana.
F, she's probably watching.
Hi, Nana.
So F. Roll up a joint, or don't. And then back to C. Follow your arrow, G, wherever it points. And then it walks down. Follow your arrow, wherever it points. And that's it, and it's the same thing over again.
Brilliant, okay, so. Okay. That's gonna be hard for some people to get.
We should have flashcards of the chords.
That would be nice.
But they're gonna pause this video. They're gonna learn it.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. But I think I cannot. I love this sentiment. Follow your arrow wherever it points. Mm-hmm. Like your arrow is your arrow.
Yeah.
My
Everybody's
arrow is
different.
My arrow. Your arrow is everyone's is
yeah.
different.
Yeah. And it's funny. Like country music can be kind of a conservative genre, obviously, and so it's just interesting that like. You know, there was some hate on this song, and
was
some
it?
Radio stations banned it. And it's just funny because it's like, in a way, I can't really hate on them because they're just following their arrow. They're
sure.
doing what they, you
That's
know what I
true.
Mean? But
yeah.
the real
that
message
is
just
arrow.
That, like, I just, you know, everybody's, you were saying earlier,
you can't
your
control.
Truth is your truth, and
you
it
can't
doesn't
control
matter,
anything
you know?
But yourself.
Yeah. So, anyway.
Should we, I feel like maybe we can try to assist you, and I'd love for the world to hear this song
Kay.
Coming from you because it's
one of my favorites. It's so brilliant. And we'll try and not mess it up, right?
No.
That's right. Awesome. That's right.
It's awesome.
Well, I'll just speak for myself. Not we. I'll try and not mess it up. Okay.
So should I just play it?
Yeah.
Like, play it, play it?
Yeah, let's play
it. Okay. We're going to kick up the tempo
a
little
bridge?
Bit. There is a bridge.
And we're
yes. Okay, bridge is, so say what you think, A minor. Love who you love. Back to C. You just get so many tricks around the sun. Yeah, you only F. I take my middle finger off because it does that. Only live back to C once. That's it.
So the main chords in this song are C, A minor, D, F.
Yep.
D minor.
Yeah, and G.
There's a D minor.
And
G, yep.
Yeah,
I'm gonna forget all of it, but let's try it.
All right.
Here we go. As long as it looks like you're into it and you're doing it.
At some point, I'll start strumming up here.
Yeah. Nice.
All right, just like.
Exactly.
Okay, all right, let's do this. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't save yourself from marriage, you're a horrible person. If you won't have a drink, then you're a prude. But they'll call you a drunk as soon as you down the first one. If you can't lose weight, then you're just fat.
No.
Oh, but if you lose too much, then you're on the crack. They'll say, you're damned if you do. Oh, yeah, so you might as well just do whatever you want. So,
make lots of noise, kiss lots of boys, or kiss lots of girls if that's something you're into. And straight and narrow gets a little too straight, roll up the joint. Just follow your arrow wherever it points, yeah. Follow your arrow wherever it points.
Yeah, hell yeah. I hear those three parts.
Woo!
So, if you don't go to church, you'll go to hell. You're the first one on the front row. You're a self-righteous son of a can't win for losing. You'll just disappoint them. Just cause you can't beat them, don't mean you should join them. So make lots of noise,
kiss lots of boys,
or kiss lots of girls if that's something you're into. And
straight and narrow gets a little too straight,
roll up the joint, or don't.
Just follow your arrow wherever it points, yeah. Follow your arrow wherever it points.
Back to the bridge, so stay on C.
Okay?
Yeah. Just say what you think. Love who you love. Cause you just get so many trips around the sun. Yeah, you only. Yeah, we only live once. Yeah.
In this costume.
Alright, chorus one more time. Here
there
we go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Don't make lots of noise.
Woo!
Kiss lots of boys.
Or
kiss lots of girls if there's something you're into. In the
straight
and narrow gets a little too straight.
Roll up a joint, I probably would.
And follow your arrow wherever it goes. Follow your arrow.
Surprisingly awesome.
We've never done that before.
Yeah,
that
Ballin' on the third part, by the way.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
We've never done that before. We've
that was
never.
So good.
Never.
We love
We you. Might have talked about the song before we came in.
We did talk about the song.
Yeah.
I called Kacey up and I was like, will you come to this strange experiment?
I was summoned. Yes.
She's like, I'm just having a fun time in Nashville. I was like, Kacey, I love you. I need you. I know the people will. love to check out both Kacey and Music Cares. Mm-hmm. And I think it's an amazing thing. You're a strong woman telling your truth, pointing your arrow in the only direction that you know how to.
Yeah.
And I'm just so...
Same.
I'm so encouraged by you, David, and the truth that you're sharing with everyone and the help that you're giving and the light that you're sharing and your music. How do we find your music?
My stuff is davidfranciscomusic.com.
David Francisco.
At davidfranciscomusic on Instagram.
Amazing. Dude, and they said you would never walk again. They told him that. And look at him. He's like...
It's a crazy story.
Who are they?
So mobile.
My whole story is redemption. I mean, I never thought I'd have a girlfriend again. I was showing her pictures of this girl.
Yeah.
She's so beautiful. I saw her. I think that's her, right?
That was her in the video.
I heard all about it.
I thought that I'd be done with music stuff, and here I am, like, hanging with you.
You're living well, I don't know. But you're living a great life.
It's all redemption. I'm very, very thankful.
Amazing.
And yeah. Happy to be here. And
we're so happy you're here, and so happy you've been thinking positive and doing the work and fighting the good fight and being a great example for other musicians out there that maybe are struggling or creative people that are struggling, and it's great. So check out musiccares.org, and thank you, Kacey.
Yay,
and I hope
thanks.
People can make this hold this video into a slow motion on what chords are what, but maybe we'll just get the chords and we'll post them on my Instagram.
Yeah.
You hear me out there?
It's really easy. It's
super
it's so easy.
It's kind of easy. I ended up just going like this at one point. I was like,
well, it looks good. So,
it was great. It was great. You know, fake it until you make it. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks
thank
for
you,
having
Kacey.
Us.
I love you.
Yeah, thank you so
and
much.
Thank you, David.
Bye, world.
Bueno.
Bye. You can say bye, but it's not going to be a bye.
Oh, right. Yeah, this keeps going.
This all keeps going.
Dude.
All right. And here's your pick, by the way.
You can have it.
Oh, awesome.
Bye,
totally
Nugget.
Keeping
oh, my gosh,
that.
Nugget.
I know.
Rusty. I want a dog so bad. I want a dog right now.
I know, right?
I got a horse since the last time I saw you.
Yeah, well, that is, by the way, that is very Kacey Musgraves.
You got a horse. Nice.
I did.
Got a
you
got
to come visit it.
She's like, I got myself a horse.
I did.
How is Nashville?
Awesome. It's so good.
I miss it so much.
You got to come back. It's growing a lot, though. It's getting a little big for its britches.
Oh, too big for its boots?
It is.
Mm-hmm. It thinks it's
But I think
awesome.
Nashville,
put, awesome.
They put on their pants one leg at a time still, right?
Yeah. I don't know. Also, the Preds.
I put on my pants one leg at a time. You ready to go, Nugget? Come on.
There we
good
go
girl.
The crazy door.
I'm sweating. Room. Also, I love this room. I think it's my fave. It looks
Isn't
like an old
fun?
Game show.
It's
Come on,
awesome.
This is so fun. This is where I live.
Wow.
This is my life now.
Cool. This
I
is an old
just,
theater too, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I wanted to say thank you for the therapy session that you posted. That was so inspirational.
Thank you.
It was really, really cool.
I appreciate that. I'm like a little hesitant to like look at it back.
Oh no, it was,
I mean,
it was,
yeah, it's awesome.
It was incredible.
Okay,
really.
Good.
And it's cool that you would share that, you know, having so many followers
I mean,
and stuff.
Who doesn't have like, you know, crazy things going on, you know?
Everyone
just,
does.
Like really doesn't matter who you are, so.
And everyone does.
I just had a similar upbringing too. And,
did you?
And really related, so.
Good,
yeah,
good. And that's the thing is like, I still believe in faith. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful and I feel God every single day.
Yeah.
I feel him every single day. And it's so beautiful how, you know, he shows himself to be true for me, even though, like, it's a journey. Like, I'm really on this strange journey. I feel it so regularly.
Yeah. That's crazy. Well,
I can't wait to come back to Nashville because people in Nashville have spirit.
Mm.
They have soul.
You should see them about the Preds.
Oh,
what's the Preds? What are Preds?
Dude, the hockey team there. They're
Preds?
Like about
what?
To win the Stanley Cup. I don't want
no
to
way.
Knock on wood.
What is
yeah.
it?
They are.
What are they called? I'm sorry,
the
I don't
predators?
Know.
Predators?
Oh, the
or the
Preds.
Tooth cats,
I don't even know. I don't even know. I
the
don't
predators?
Love sports, but I'm like happy
so,
they're winning.
So, but like everybody is talking
it's,
about the Preds.
They're freaking out. They're freaking
who are they
right going
to play?
Who are they playing?
It's Pittsburgh.
That's right.
Pittsburgh something.
The Ducks?
Penguins.
Oh,
Pittsburgh Penguins.
I don't know.
Okay, well, I don't know anything and I don't want to choose sides, but I love Nashville so much, so I just want to say go Predators.
Yeah.
Go Predators.
Go
yeah.
Awesome. Hey, also, Save His Draft. That is my fave.
You
that
like
one.
It?
It could be a country song. I was
Thank
like,
you.
Yeah.
Well, some of these songs I feel really either are worship songs or yeah. country songs.
Yeah.
Right?
Or both.
Yeah. Or both. I know.
Yeah,
no,
really...
I love that one. Thank you so much for having me.
I love
us.
You so
love
much.
You.
I love you so much.
I love you. Thank you.
I think
so
you
much.
Are so special.
Thank you.
And check Seriously. Out her music. It's amazing.
There's new ones coming.
I cannot Excited. Wait. But all of them are great.
Thank
all of
you.
Your little truth teas.
Thanks.
And have a safe flight, and thank you so much for coming to
yes.
Witness Worldwide.
I loved it.
We love
it was
you.
So fun. Thank
love
you.
Love you, David.
Thank you.
Bye.
Oh, shit.
Really Thanks so much, man.
Okay.
Good luck on your journey. God bless you.
Thank you.
And tell your girlfriend I say hello. Or
I will.
Hi. What's her
hi,
name?
Hi, Christy.
Hi, Christy. You're a wonderful woman.
Yes.
We can already all tell.
Oh, yeah, she is.
Oh, yeah, he will not shut up about you.
Why
really
should
cute.
He?
It's really No, no, it's really
Why
cute.
Should he?
No, no reason.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
See you again.
Bye. Thank
God
you.
Bless
See
you.
Later.
Love you.
Bless you.
Bye. Let's put on the record. I want to move it, move it. I like to, if you haven't noticed, I'm a night owl. So I really like come alive in the evening. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. If I lost it all today, would you stay? Would my muffin be enough to stimulate? If it hit the fan, then it's good. I am so excited for this dinner coming up. Woo!
Got it.
You got that coffee?
Yeah, I guess the coffee's kicking in.
Do you want a little break before we do this?
Yeah, I want to talk to everyone online.
Okay. Let me get your iPad.
I want to talk to the people. I only got this life. I ain't got the time. Not to get it right. Ooh, look at that meat. Look at all this meat. Look at all this meat. Look at this meat. What is this meat? Well, I'm ready to wag my wagyu. I am ready. Looks good. I'm ready to eat. Yes. 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 What happens when this stops and I'm still performing? Ah, that's my whole life.
Basically every day.
That's basically, this is what I'm doing every day. Honestly, like,
do you want me to leave
Tamara as a witness, and this is for all the Tamara. You can turn the camera right there to Tamara. She hates this right now. But as one of my witnesses for, what, over 7 years?
8 years in December, but who's counting?
She always is. She always
is.
She's always telling me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
8 years of torture.
On a scale of like 1 to 10, how am I like this? How much of this is real?
On a scale of 1 to 10?
Yeah.
All of it.
That's not a number, Tamara.
10. This is just her every day. We all have to deal with it.
Oh deal with it. Like it's a bad thing. Great, thanks so much. 8 years of
my
damn.
Love it.
Eight years of my damn life. But damn life. Before I go live. Could you be the one who speaks to me? I'm sorry. Oh, we're about to, so we're 10 minutes away? Why don't we-
10 minutes away? We're I'm however sorry. Many minutes you want it to be away.
Well, why don't we invite everybody in-
Have a drink?
To have a cocktail and I will join
you
them.
You come down when you're ready.
I will come down when I'm ready. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just gonna take a little mini break. And my coffee's
no,
really kicking in.
We can let everyone in like, to have a drink
woo!
And then she'll come down when she's ready.
I am cracked out. Woo!
Yes, please.
Woo!
Work the runway.
Work.
I just have one question for you.
Okay. Yeah.
Great. Thank you. No.
Who else?
Is me? Whoever wants to, and Marcus.
Small.
It's going to take a minute.
A big beautiful brain with a pretty face. Yeah. A baby doll with a briefcase. Yeah. A hot little hurricane.
I'm so happy. I have no idea. I haven't really talked to the outside world. I don't have my phone. It feels good. It feels good. It feels good. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Hello, friend. I think some of the makeup is starting to.
Yeah.
Well, it's starting to move just a tad, tiny, tiny, tiny. Like a little bit of a fresh. Just like a little. Here. Yeah, make it. Move it. I like to move it, move it. And I can't beat this one. Yeah, I smell like a rose and I pierce like a thorn. Yeah, karate chopping the cliches and norms all in a dress. Chatting, I'm going live. Join me. I'm going to answer a few of your questions in the next 10 minutes. Who's the first one? 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 Oh! Hey, Aya. Oh, hi. Hi, Wendell. Hi, King. Hi, Larissa. That's okay. I got it. Hi, Teenage Dreamer. Hey, hey, hey. Hi, Maddie. I got it. Hi, Thomas Brown. What's that?
We just need to mirror it so that people at home can see all the nice things.
Oh, okay. Hi, hi, hi. Hola. Are you guys watching? Hello, Poplars. Hello. Hello. I'm glad you're liking it. Thank you. Hi, Super Girly Simmer. Hi, Sam. Hi, Christian Kawaii. Hey, Crack Crack. I love your name, Crack Crack. Let's crack crack. Hi, Anika. Hi, Gamer GG140. Hi, Pedro. Hi, Paula. Hi, Diego. Hi, Giovanni. Hi, Shahad. Adrian Rodriguez. Mad Dog. Am I doing it right?
Sorry. No, you're doing fine. You can
hi,
keep
Georgie.
Talking.
Hi, Georgie. It paused.
I'm by the rules in is it working out?
Life. Hi, Brittany Gustin. Hi, Lady Miss Moody. Ooh, yes. I'm just going to dinner, and I have some guests coming up. And I wanted just to look, you know, a little presentable because it's been a bit of a day. It's still a Sunday. It's the Lord's Day. Hi, Tattoo. Hi, Rebecca. Hi, Tiffany. Hi, Philippe. Hi, Jason. Happy birthday, Jason. Hi, Liv. Thank you. Hi, Natasha. Hi, Indian girl. Your girl. Hi, Anna. Hi, Truth. Okay, there's Natalie Flip. There are a bunch of people coming to dinner. Some of you may know. I'm coming to dinner. Who is coming to dinner?